Jake Carey has been his second on vault at the World Championships. So will it be gold this time around? Jordan Chiles seeks her first individual world medal to go along with the team title. Shailese Jones is flying high after winning silver in the all-around. She'll be back in action today on the uneven bars. And Steven Nedorozic looks to defend his world title on pommel horse from a year ago. It's the first of 2 days of individual event finals at the World Gymnastics Championships. Five finals, five Americans, up next. NBC Sports welcomes you to the 2022 World Gymnastics Championships. Been a great week already. Fans turning out in full force. First time ever. World Championships being held in Liverpool, Merseyside. M&S Bank Arena is the site. The fans have filed in once again today. It's the individual apparatus finals. Terry Gannon along with one of the stars from Rio, Lori Hernandez and John Roethlisberger, the four-time U.S. champ. So here's the lineup for today. Going to start with the men on floor. Five different apparatus finals coming your way. And then another day tomorrow to close out this 51st edition of the World Championships. Men's floor gets it underway, then women's vault. Back to the men for pommel horse. Women's uneven bars, and we'll round it out with the men's still rings. Lori, first of all, great to be with you here.
Same here. This is so exciting. You know, Worlds always has the next Olympic Games in mind, so how you do under pressure here can raise or lower your chances of making this next team. It's going to be an exciting watch.
Biggest annual event in gymnastics, no doubt about it. I mentioned the five Americans in action today. What are you most looking forward to seeing?
Shailese Jones on bars. She's going up against Andrade, Seitz, Sterwile, and other fantastic bar workers, so she's going to need some really clean hit routines in order to get that podium medal.
And Arazic, too, trying to defend that world title. First American to win that world title on pommel horse. With more on the Americans, we join John.
I spoke with Chelsea Memel today, the high-performance technical lead for USA Gymnastics, and she told me that the women's spirits this morning at breakfast were great and that training over the last couple days has been very good. She went on to say for Jordan Chiles, she just needs to go and do what she did in qualifications. That is as good as Chelsea has seen her on the vault. For Jade Carey, she's very disappointed she didn't win that medal in the all-around competition, but her training has been very good as well, and this is a bit of a chance at redemption for a medal that she did not get at the Tokyo Olympics. Chelsea told me that her message to the athletes today is going to be the same as it's been throughout these world championships. Do your normal. So far for the U.S. women, normal's been pretty darn good.
Yeah, it hasn't been bad. Another team championship. You're part of that legacy. So we get the action underway. First man out there on floor exercise, the 23-year-old from Kazakhstan, Milad Karimi. Qualified for floor exercise final in third.
Two falls, that's going to cost him 2 points in that overall score. Unfortunately, it looks like he won't be medaling today.
Laura, you mentioned how big the World Championships are in the eyes of gymnasts. The pressure you get to a final like this early on in this routine, maybe that coming into play.
Absolutely. Individual finals are a great place for athletes to show off, again, individuality compared to team finals. This is your moment to shine. This is your event. So the pressure is on. Tough floor routine for Milad Karimi. Everything else was clean, though.
So we get things underway here. That first routine in floor exercise, not the one he was looking for. The man who finished fifth in floor exercise at the Tokyo Olympics. He was eighth at high bar there, too. So we saw him compete in Tokyo and now here in Liverpool.
We've got that replay of the first fall. Quite under-rotated there. Always makes your heart drop mid-skill when you recognize this one isn't going to work out.
You know it midway through?
Oh, yeah. Sometimes you can tell by the run, but you never give up hope. Keep pulling forward. Sometimes that skill will still come to get you. Also, that twist at the end, a little bit short there. Curious to see if he'll get credit.
Let's get the thoughts of John Roethlisberger, who's in Liverpool. John?
Yeah, obviously not a great performance from Milad Karimi. He will not be on the medal stand, most likely, unless there's a lot of mistakes. And here, if you're watching at home, here's what I would do on floor. The guy that is going to end up on the top of the podium, not only is going to land on his feet every time, but count his stuck landings. In my opinion, the winner is going to have to stick close to half of their passes to win the gold medal. So just to break it down in very simplistic terms, to have your little check sheet at home, count the stuck landings, and that very likely is going to be your winner.
All right, I'm scoring at home, just like in baseball. I'm doing it right now with you. Ryosuke Doi from Japan will be next, but we wait for the numbers now for Milad Karimi, 23-year-old. It's always got to be excruciating waiting for the numbers, but especially after you struggled in a routine. Oof.
Yeah, also watching the judges reconvene afterwards when you've made a couple mistakes, there's a curiosity. What are they saying? I know what went wrong, but what do they think?
Are you looking over there and paying attention to that? You're trying not to, probably.
For the athlete's sake, I hope they are not doing that, but I sure did.
So there's the wait for the number for that gymnast, but then there's the wait for the person going next,
yes.
Which the longer it takes, it's like icing the kicker in football.
And when you're competing after someone who's just had two falls or any sort of mistakes, it can make you feel a lot more pressure in that routine. Can I hit? You know, that representation can mess with the brain a little bit. Competing under pressure is a mind game.
Does it become contagious too? Mistakes or people doing very well?
Unfortunately, mistakes can be a domino effect for one athlete to the other. It doesn't just mean, you know, if Team USA is going up or if one country is going up and one athlete makes a mistake, that everyone else will make a mistake. It's everywhere.
So you see the difficulty and the execution, and overall 12.1. Milad Karimi, the 23-year-old from Kazakhstan.
And now, representing Japan,
Ryosuke Doi, the 20-year-old from Japan. He was part of that team effort. Japan looked like they came in as one of the favorites in that team final along with China, and they ended up capturing the silver medal. This young man qualified for the floor final in second.
He did step out of bounds. Every tenth does matter, but overall, his twisting form is fantastic. My jaw was on the floor watching that.
Man who missed the trials for the Olympics because of an injury. Go back to 2019. He was at the World Junior Championships and came in second in the all-around there, fourth in floor exercise.
Helped Japan win a team title.
Yep. Came up just shy here at Worlds this time around. Japan in the team championship, the team event. You're someone who's competed You know what this is like. When we slow that down, it's amazing the positions in the air. Are you sometimes shocked?
I am sometimes shocked, especially, you know, when you're in it, you don't get to see those slow motion replays. But out here, gymnastics is marvelous, especially at this level, you know, as someone who's done it. But even for those who haven't done it, there is so much awe in watching what a human body can do.
It's amazing. It is. All right. See the difficulty in execution, so much higher for the execution. 14-2-6-6, Ryosuke Doi from Japan. ...26-year-old from Italy, Nicola Bartolini next. 2021 world champ on floor exercise. Helped Italy to a fourth place finish this week in the team event. Eighth man to qualify on floor.
Incredible height on that double pike front half.
I think things have just been taken up a notch.
So this is definitely an exciting watch.
Yeah, the only athlete from the men's team for Italy to make an apparatus final. There you go. Okay, then. All right.
Oh, he's excited. I'm excited, too. Okay, crowd word.
World champ trying to do it again. John, pretty impressive.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, that's what we talked about. Got to stick the landing. Bartolini starts from a 15.9, or at least that's what he did in the qualification. And he's going to have to be perfect. He was down near the bottom of the standings of the finalists competing. So sticking that dismount at the end, those types of things. I think the fist pumps, honestly, at the end, those don't hurt either. So he did himself good there. We'll see how it holds up.
You think that influences the judges at all? The celebration when an athlete is thrilled with what they just did?
Listen, I was always told to smile before saluting because it might coerce the judges into giving me a better score if they thought I was real nice, but who knows?
Nice, excited, proud of the effort. Yeah.
I thought I saw some mobile style height up here.
And one of the things that maybe you don't feel at home, this crowd here has not just been fans of the British gymnast. They love great gymnastics. So the fist bump at the end, the crowd even ramped it up even louder. Absolutely, this is a subjective sport. I think it makes a difference. In this crowd, it is pumped, and they love
it. They don't
gymnastics.
Like this number right now, though. Wow. 14.233 in the second. Yeah, he doesn't like it. He's like, Ryosuke, who went... What's like, no.
Just a hair lower than Doi. Wow.
Benjamin Osberger from France, a 21-year-old who wasn't originally in the lineup for this event final. Zhangbo Hung from China was one of those who qualified, withdrew. So he is in, able to compete. Finished just outside the top eight in qualifying.
sticky feet. I'm going to listen to John and start keeping a tally mark of all the stuck landings we see today.
Too. The crowd's right there with every one of these gymnasts. They've been fantastic through the week. Benjamin Osberger from France. John, what do you think?
Yeah, you know, Kim, he comes in with the lowest start value of the finalists. His game plan is, you know what, you have to stick every landing to give yourself a chance. He didn't stick every landing, but so far out of the finalists, he stuck the most landings. He did what he could do. He maximized that execution score. Now it's up to the judges.
Hey, John, before you, I turn to Lori here. Your thoughts on Carlos Yulo, who we're going to see coming up here. He was sensational in the team event. The favorite coming in?
Absolutely. And if anybody watched the competition in the all-around, Tim Daggett, he's full of hyperbole. We all know that. But he said it's the greatest routine that he has ever seen. And I might have to agree with him. And that's why guys like Benjamin here have to be perfect and stick every landing. Because Yulo, he has got the start value, the highest start value, and the highest execution score. That is a deadly combination.
Yeah, I sat up straight in my chair and took notice when he said that. The greatest routine he's ever seen. It's not often that he goes that far.
Yeah, a lot of times the strategy is to either go in with a heavy amount of difficulty or to lower it a little bit and just be super clean. But to have both, that is somebody you have to watch out for.
Ryosuke Doi, the leader so far, 14-2-3-3. Right there, it's the same number as Bartolini. So midway through the men's floor exercise, the individual apparatus finals taking place today and tomorrow at the World Championships. Ryosuke Doi from Japan, the youngster, 20-year-old who set the World Juniors a couple of years ago, missed the Tokyo Olympics because of an ankle injury, but the leader at this point. But you've still got Carlos Yulo, who's said to come, and Daiki Hashimoto will be the last man to go, the newly crowned world all-around champ. Is Yulo getting set? I mean, this routine is something else. The 22-year-old from Manila, just sensational. He led after the opening rotation of the individual all-around. And a busy man, too. He's on floor, did the all-around. He got to the vault final and the parallel bars final.
Yeah, I've seen a lot of excitement on Twitter, especially about Yulo's floor routine as one to look out for. Do you have someone you're looking forward to?
This man right here. He'll round it out. The gold medalist in the all-around at the Olympics and now the World Championships. Your thoughts, John?
Yeah, it's been fun to talk to Hashimoto in the mix zone after the competition. And I asked him yesterday, after he won the world all-around title, I said, what are people going to say about you when your career is over? Will they say you are the greatest gymnast? Do you want them to say you are the greatest gymnast ever? And he said no. Immediately said no. He said, no, gymnastics to me, it's about fun. It's about going out there and doing your best. It wasn't for him about having the greatest legacy in the history of men's gymnastics.
Interesting. Kohei Ujimura maybe considered that. Oh, hang on. Motivation different for every gymnast, every athlete.
Absolutely. Some come in with this heavy competitive streak of, I'm going to win, I'm going to dominate. And there's no wrong mindset to come into a competition. Whereas some, as John mentioned earlier, say, this is for fun, this is play, this is what sparks my joy and makes me happy. There is no wrong place to put your motivation.
At
as long as you have motivation.
How you view it, not work. This is play. This is fun.
Exactly. And a lot of times with the play mindset, we'll see a lot of fun gymnastics, a lot of athletes throwing out new skills.
I'll say one thing. Yeah. This is going to be fun.
Oh, yeah.
So watch this. Carlos Yulo, the 22-year-old from the Philippines, just about ready on floor.
on that first pass.
Reminiscent of qualification. Back to Tokyo. Shocking start to that routine for a man who won the world championship on floor back in 2019, was one of the favorites going into Tokyo, and then really struggled in qualifying, including an opening fall.
You'll hear this a lot from me today, but gymnastics is a mind game. To have a fall as your first pass, you really have to immediately reset your mind and start new. Otherwise, the routine can just go downhill. But he did finish strong.
John,
lots of hops on the landing.
John, that mistake right from the start.
Yeah, you know, it looked like he's a little short on it, but it almost looked like he was trying to be too perfect, which is unfortunate. He doesn't have to be perfect. He's the one athlete, unlike some that we've already seen, that doesn't have to stick every landing. He's going to stick his fair share, but he's got the big start value. And, you know, that first pass, it's a risk-reward. He should just take a step forward out of it and move on to the big stuff he has coming. So that's disappointing. That's going to, in my opinion, going to keep him off the medal stand.
So definitely an opening, not only for those who have already gone, like Doi from Japan, but those still to come. Yep, there you go. 13.3, currently in fourth. Wow. Yosuke Doi from Japan sits and waits. Top the leaderboard. Listen to the crowd now.
I love the energy of this crowd. I can feel it through the screen.
Jarni Rajini Moran, one of the stars from Great Britain. See the qualifying score. Here he goes.
Triple twisting, double-double coming.
But his teammates watching. It may add pressure, a home world championships, but boy, that feeling's got to be good when you're done and you hear that noise.
To hit a routine in front of your home and your people probably feels like a huge relief, to be honest. Look at that. Big step back, but that is a huge skill to be competing at a world stage.
Again, those positions in the air, when you slow it down, just amazing. This man, part of that effort for Team GB that got the bronze medal, and this place went nuts.
Mm-hmm.
fought just to get to this point. After Tokyo, went through three surgeries, one on each shoulder, ankle surgery, but back among the world's best. Gianni Regini Moran, James Hall, Joe Frazier, his teammates up there. Should have better seats than that, I think. They're way up in the rafters.
You would think athletes do get designated seating, but...
it's way up there. Ryosuke Doi is the man who leads so far. Still have a couple of gymnasts to go.
Wow.
First place. Great Britain.
Look at that smile. In his home country, nonetheless. Lots of pride there.
2015, the last time Great Britain had a medal on floor. Max Whitlock, that was a silver, so trying to take it one step farther. Yoo Sung-hyun up next, the 20-year-old from South Korea. Qualified for this floor exercise final in sixth place, actually qualified for the all-around final, but withdrew.
Yoo Sung-hyun came fourth in floor exercise at the Tokyo Olympics. I believe that was a 3.5.
So he got close at the Olympics, just missed the podium, and here trying to make it to one of those steps. Fourth at the 2021 World Championships, too. So he's kind of stuck in fourth place the last couple of big time events. Regini Moran on top. John, do you have more?
Yeah, this is a good routine, but it's not going to be good enough, in my opinion, to take over the lead. Will it be good enough to get him on the podium? Too many hops on the landing. Those little deductions, man, the judges, just they'll be happy to take three every time you take a hop just like that. So I don't know that he can get on the podium with that, but it was a decent performance nonetheless.
Agree?
I do agree with that. What's tough is that at the end of the day, you want to hit a clean routine and you want to have as high of difficulty as you can do, but if you know something isn't going to work out, if you know you've been training something and it's not working out in practice, it's smarter to pull it. So when we see high difficulty routines here at Worlds and we see either cleanliness or the latter, it gets a little nerve-wracking because we don't know what they're doing. We don't know what angle they're playing at.
14.2 into fifth, so it is still Regini Moran on top of the leaderboard, and Great Britain's never won a gold medal in this event. But here is the Olympic and now world all-around champ, Daiki Hashimoto, as big a name as there is at the World Championships, and he will close it out with a chance to win the gold medal.
On that triple twisting double back. Gotta keep an eye out on that chest. His chest is landing quite low on these landings.
wait to see if it was enough.
I gotta be honest, I don't know where this is gonna land him on the podium, and I'm really curious of John's thoughts on this one.
Yeah, I think it's not enough to overtake Giarni. You know, they did very similar gymnastics. They both opened with the same two passes, triple twisting, double back, and double twisting, double back. And quite frankly, I think Hashimoto, as you mentioned, low on the landings and hops, and it just opens the door for too many deductions. I don't think that routine's good enough for gold, but I do think he ends up on the podium somewhere.
Virginie Moran from Great Britain, right now leading Rosique Doy in second, Osberger from France in third. So we'll get the numbers for the now reigning Olympic and world all-around champ. So it could be one of those moments here, if this number is not enough, where we'll just listen to this crowd, because it would be the first ever gold for Great Britain in this event. 14.5, second place. Close, but not good enough. It's Virginie Moran who wins the gold for Great Britain.
Listen to that crowd. To win a gold in your home country at a world championships is absolutely fantastic.
First ever gold medal in this event for Great Britain. 24-year-old Giarni Virginie Moran. Pretty cool moment, John.
Yeah, for Virginie Moran. Yeah, it is quite a moment. That man thought about retiring at one point because of injuries. Didn't even think he would be able to continue the sport a number of years ago. So to go from that to this moment on your home floor, doing something that no British gymnast has done before, real special.
Taiki Hashimoto, the last man to go. How that was scripted with the all-around champ going last, right? One of the biggest names here, maybe the biggest name. And coming up just shy, Virginie Moran from Great Britain, the gold medal in floor exercise at Worlds. .com, home of youth sports. Pretty thrilling open to this apparatus, day of apparatus finals. Floor exercise won by Virginie Moran from Great Britain. So we turn now to the women's vault, and here is the lineup here, and you see two Americans have made it to the final, Jordan Chiles, Jade Carey, Lori.
Yes, we have some athletes here who rival Jade and Jordan's difficulty. So a gold on the podium is not a concrete thing. We're looking for cleanliness, we're looking for difficulty, and of course, we've seen lots of different hiccups between Andrade and Dana Wittenberg on having these mistakes. So can they hit when the pressure's on?
You mentioned Rebecca Andrade, the world all-around champ, and the world champ in this event, 2021. Kind of a fluke mistake, slip in qualifying, did not make it to the final.
Yeah, for Andrade to not make a vault final was something that I was really quite shocked at. I expected her name to be up on this board, but as of now, these are the athletes that we have. We'll see her eventually in finals on other events. So vault is going to be a party today.
Yeah, Great Britain starting it off too. Jessica Gadarova, we've watched her all week, and it'll get loud again inside M&S Bank Arena. So the announcements being made of those competing in the vault final for the women. That's next. Back getting set now for the women's vault individual event. Jessica Gadarova from Great Britain will start it out. Jordan Chiles, who was terrific in qualifying, Jade Carey, and sixth, and Shoko Miyato will be the last one to go, the eighth athlete, eight make it to the finals. Thoughts on this lineup?
Yeah, this lineup is definitely going to be powerful. I don't believe that a gold is concrete for any athlete here. Everyone's really going to have to show up today. Jaden Jordan are known as our powerhouses. So let's see how high they go.
And Rebecca Andrade not making it to the final, and that certainly opens it up for the other gymnasts, John.
Yeah, it certainly does, and it's unfortunate. You know, she does, in my opinion, the best vault in the world. She did that first vault in the qualification round. It was amazing. However, on her second vault for Yurchenko double full, she did the back handspring up onto the table, and her hand slipped, and you could see the video. It's kind of scary, and Lori, maybe you can comment on what it's like to feel that on the vault, but she slid her hands and she pulled back, only did a tuck flip out of that vault, so she did not make the finals. Disappointing to not see the world and Olympic champion on the vault here in the finals.
Yeah, to have a mistake like that, to have your hands slide back on the vault, especially during a competition vault, a competition routine that you're doing, it makes your heart drop completely out of your body. A, it's nerve-wracking. Of course, naturally, everyone's watching going, oh, it's a fall, oh, her start value. But also, it's a safety issue. To not know where you are in the air, that, you know, we don't practice slipping and falling. We practice as close to perfection as we can get. So to watch professional athletes, to watch these professional gymnasts slip, it is nerve-wracking.
See Ellie Black a moment ago. She's been a star once again here, and still at the age of 27, one of the top names, making it to the podium over and over again. Colleen Daviar from France, one of those in the lineup here for the final. France has won a couple of medals in this event. Bronze medals back in 2009 and go all the way back to 1950. Simone Biles, the last U.S. gymnast to win the world title, 2018-2019. And the U.S. has also had a couple of gymnasts on the podium at the same time. Jake Carey, Simone in 2019, the last time that happened. Stuttgart that year, the World Championships, originally leading up to the Olympics, which were then delayed a year.
What's also really interesting is...
Whoa, hang on.
Her hand almost missed the table there, so you definitely want to keep an eye out on that competition. But overall, for World Championships, I feel like we've seen Simone's name over and over and over again within the last short decade. So to not see her here is interesting, but it means we get to highlight all these athletes that are here.
And it's got to be a different feeling at it. You know it from the Olympic side, just to... Even the first day you arrive and go to training and you see the other athletes, it's different. When it's a world championship and the best in the world are all there.
Absolutely.
Or at the Olympics, too.
Yeah, there's this level of intimidation that happens when you start training. You know, in the week leading up to world championships or any sort of elite competition, you're watching these athletes from across the world do these high-level skills, and a lot of us are thinking, oh, man, okay, we've got some showing up to do. This is what we trained for.
By the way, I don't see Jessica Gadarova out there right now. I'm wondering. She was to be the first one to go. See if they make an announcement. And update you as soon as we find something out. What are you trying to accomplish right here? And I mean, just obviously, you're just warming up. But specifically in the vault that you're choosing. What are you trying to get done right here in warm-ups?
Right here in warm-ups, we only get about two or three vaults to warm up before we go and compete. And when we're at practice, we can do anywhere up to 10, 20. So right now, a lot of these, the women athletes have been standing around for a while watching the men compete. And now you're trying to warm up your body. You're doing these high-level skills. It's nerve-wracking.
A couple of vaults take the average. Lihi Raz, and we're being told, who was just outside of the top eight to qualify, is in the lineup now for Jessica Gadarova. We don't have any reason. We'll get you that as soon as we can. Representing Israel, Raz will take the place of Gadarova, first to go. And And we're being told that it's a foot soreness, not an injury per se, but foot soreness for Jessica Gaidarova after the team final. Hopefully she'll be good to go tomorrow for day two of the individual event finals.
I do wonder how long ago Roz found out that she would be subbing in and competing today for vault finals.
Yeah, that's got to be awfully tough, right?
Yeah, we saw that with
Michaela
Skinner.
But on some level, as an athlete, it doesn't give you time to think about it. You just react.
I would prefer that. No time to think is more often than not better. Here she goes. Oh. We've got a fall, hands and knees for that first vault.
The Roz, who was born in New York City, competes for Israel. Just doesn't quite get there. So we'll wait and get the number now.
We saw in that replay, midair as she's twisting, you see her head poke out, her arms open up quite a bit right there. Slowing down her twisting, slowing down her rotation and her speed. Unfortunately, that is going to cost her quite a bit.
Roz, who in 2020 at the European Championships won bronze on floor exercise, Israel's first medal, and that was in Tokyo competing at the Olympics.
It's tough sometimes when you don't get enough block on that table. Your vault, the height, is too low. And more often than not, like this, you can't fix it midair.
All right, so 12.133, the number for the first one. We'll see the second one to take the average.
Now up to her to clear her mind, take a deep breath, reset, and start this new vault. Bit of a pike down, but overall, almost a stuck landing. So we'll see in just a few moments how this averages out with that first vault she did.
Go back to the point you brought up. Could be unsettling finding out basically at the last minute that you're in the final. That's not the normal preparation.
Yeah, to bring up Michaela Skinner at the Tokyo Games, you know, she had to sub in and she had her bags packed, she had her leotards in the suitcase, and then suddenly they look and say, hey, Skinner,
you're up,
you're going, and now you gotta unpack the leotards from the bag, unpack all your tape, you know. That's really unsettling. That's, you know, to have to switch your mindset like that suddenly from I'm going home or I'm done with the competition to I am now competing at the world stage.
How strict are you with your routine?
I am extremely strict with my routine. If something changes, it can throw me off pretty quick. Hate to admit that, but that is how it is. Sometimes the superstition makes us think that's what's gonna make us do well. But at the end of the day, it's in our bodies.
So vault 2, 13.066, and the average 12.599. That's the standard that has been set.
Up next, we've got Colleen Deviar of France.
So Colleen Deviar, who qualified in third, the 22-year-old, part of the team effort for France. They finished eighth.
She got some really nice height on that ball. Height and distance is something that you can get deducted for, so we are looking for that.
French vault champ 2021.
I was told she sustained another ankle injury and a fractured thumb this summer. So to heal and be at a world championships, that is fantastic healing on her end.
Yeah, two straight years where she missed the world championships, 2018, 2019, with injuries.
And missing world championships due to injuries or due to pulling out, not making it, it just adds to that pressure when you do make it of, okay, I'm here. I don't know when I'm going to be here next. I have to do a good job.
So the number up on the board, you see that? Qualification. It's amazing how quiet an arena can get after it was so loud just a few moments ago, right?
You can hear a pin drop.
Execution 9-1, so 14-5, and now our second ball.
High execution on vault is something more common in women's artistic gymnastics, but still, seeing a 9-1 is always surprising to me.
Going to bring up because Kalina's got 6/10 of an advantage in start value over Jordan Childs, and if you're wondering if the Americans can get on the podium, for Jordan it's about execution. And so this big step forward that she has with low shoulders on that vault, that right there, if Jordan can execute cleanly, in my opinion, if she ends up on the podium, that is why, that step.
Every tenth matters. Every step, every out of bounds line, every low chest on a landing. We'll see the height here, right there. Off the table, bit of a leg separation there. Again, John, as you mentioned, this is something where Jordan and Jade can both sneak in here and get higher scores just by cleaning up.
If you are in this final and you're still to come, are you paying attention to this?
I sure hope not. I know I don't want to speak for anybody. For a lot of us, it's important to keep your head down, not watch who goes before you, because as I mentioned earlier, that domino effect is really powerful. You watch one athlete go, they fall, suddenly everybody in the line is falling. Doesn't matter where you're from. It really can get in your head. So
nothing that happens here is going to affect what you're going to do later in terms of changing something. You see fault number two, 13.833, then 14.166 for Colleen. The VR, but
exactly.
You don't make adjustments based on what somebody else has done before you.
Again, I personally would not. I know Team USA is not notorious for adding in new skills, trying new things at the last minute. When whatever we train at practice, we do in competition.
Gotcha.
But we have seen it from other countries where they watch us do something and they go, oh, I don't like that. I need more. And a new skill is in, or a new connection is in. So
next one up is the 20-year-old from South Korea, Yo So Jung, who qualified in fourth, the Tokyo Olympic bronze medalist on vault. Oh, hang on. It's okay.
That was a bit of a low vault. I'm hoping we'll get a replay on that, but that landing is really gonna, we call it crunching the ankles. You land short, kind of pinches the back of your calves. Just not enough height off that table. Again, when you're too low, you can only do so much to bring yourself higher, but the ground is gonna come whether we like it or not. Gravity is present.
Can't argue with gravity.
Can't argue with gravity. Let's see this again. Right there. We see her head out as well. For everyone watching, to keep an eye out on that head while the athletes are twisting off the table right there. Should be kind of down, looking towards your armpit. If it's out and looking to the sky, you're going to unravel in the air, and unfortunately, mistakes like that fall is common.
Seems to be okay physically. Think back to that Olympic bronze medal, it was Jade Carey, who was a big one of the favorites coming in, and the disappointment of not making it to the podium, but then coming back and winning the floor exercise the next night. But Yo So Jung able to take advantage and make it to the podium. Saw the number there.
What's hard about this also is that an athlete in track may be able to use their fear, their anxiousness, their adrenaline before competing to run faster. For gymnastics, you can't use that. It'll change the entire skill. You have to bring yourself down. So, unfortunately, we do see a lot of mistakes in competition. Yurchenko double full. John, I'm curious of your thoughts on these last two vaults.
Yeah, honestly, it opens the door wide open for the Americans to get back to that same spot they were after qualifications. They came in as the top two scorers. And in my opinion, Deviar and Yo were the top two gymnasts that could pressure them for the silver and the gold. And quite frankly, they didn't perform. But I think the door is wide open. If they do what they did in qualifications, I think the Americans get first and second again.
Ellie Black will be up next, and then it is Jordan Chiles and Jade Carey back-to-back for the U.S.
I also believe with the mistakes that we've seen in the last couple vaults from the last few athletes, I think Ellie Black could really get in there if she hits and she can hit clean. Once again, as John mentioned, the door is wide open. Mistakes do matter. This entire competition is like a game of chess. You make one wrong move and the game is over.
Five more gymnasts left here in the women's vault. Second of two apparatus finals coming your way today. One. 14.033 for the second one. The average 13.349 into second place. Yo So Jung, a 20-year-old from South Korea. WR still with the lead. So Ellie Black from Canada. One of, if not the very best gymnast from Canada, and still making it to the podium, helping the team get there this week. Here she is, first vault.
Very clean vault from Ellie Black. We saw, for the most part, her feet together, a tight shape in the air, lots of distance from the table. That is exactly what we're looking for in vault. This is her sixth qualifier for vault final, so she is a consistent athlete. We see her name constantly throughout the years, and she's here again.
Fifth in the all-around on Thursday after helping Team Canada and competing in all four events in the team event, win the bronze medal, their first ever team medal at the World Championships.
Last year during Simone's tour, I got to go on the tour as well, and Ellie Black was a part of it. And I just have to say, her joy for gymnastics is contagious. She loves this sport. She is passionate about it. I was texting her beforehand, and she had mentioned this weekend is going to be so much fun.
And we see athletes, gymnasts, more now sticking around and continuing to compete than we used to.
Exactly. Ellie Black is 27 years old, and when I was growing up, most professional athletes, or most elite gymnasts, especially in women's artistic, would drop out around the 22 years old to 24 year old mark. Of course, we had Oksana Chusovitna, who was here in her 40s, and
entirely
I marveled at that. Yeah. Just marveled at that. But for Ellie Black, who's 27, we have Elizabeth Seitz, who is going to be on the uneven bars. She's 29 years old. They really are paving the way for women's artistic gymnasts to keep going, to keep persevering. You don't have to stop at a young age.
14. We can be like the men and be older.
14, and go to college and then come back to the elite level.
Yes.
14-2, the number for the first one. Here's the second.
I gotta say, these two vaults were very strong for Ellie Black. I got a good feeling about that. John, what are your thoughts?
Oh, I agree. Sukihara, 1.5 twist here, and she's just been infallible this entire World Championships. I spoke with her after they won that team medal, and she is a special gymnast, but an incredible person, too. Just all about the team and all about Team Canada. And I had mentioned earlier at this World Championship, she hoped to get Team Canada to a medal podium finish in the team by Paris. She just moved that timeline up quite a bit here in Liverpool.
Three-time Olympian, as Lloyd said, 27 years of age. And I'm not sure anybody enjoys competing on this stage any more than Ellie Black.
I would have to agree with that. Once again, look at that smile. Her joy is contagious. She wants to do well. And what's wonderful about her as an athlete, she wants others to do well. And I don't want to say we don't see that often, because we do. And we saw an interview, did we see an interview? We may see an interview eventually where Jordan talks about being a leader. She speaks about that. And about
saw that a couple of days ago.
Yeah, her role with Team USA.
Second place. WR France in first place. Holds on to that placement. Up 0.05 of a point, I believe, between those two. Yep, there you go. That's what it is. That's the difference. So Ellie Black, oh so close, but
it really does depend on the rest of these athletes. I think for men's floor, it really showed us that you can't leave anybody out. You can't determine who's going to be on podium until all the athletes are finished competing. So depending how this group goes, let's see if Ellie can get to the podium.
Yep. WR would be the first medal for France in this event since 2009. So the Americans are coming up next. They're warming up right now. Take it back to that team final and what they did for the U.S. to help win that gold medal. We'll take a look. Jordan Chiles and Jade Carey, obviously both big parts of that team win. Jade Carey. So Jade, obviously one of the favorites coming in to this final, but Jordan Chiles has been sensational too in vault.
Once again, Jaden Jordan on vault is Team USA's powerhouses. We see their speed, their agility, we see how fast they twist, and most importantly, we see how they can land. John?
Yeah, talking to Chelsea Memel today about these two athletes, and starting with Jade, one thing Jade's been working on is the form on her free flight. If there is an error that the judges see, it's that free flight form. You'll notice when she has her hands on the table, that is something that she has been working on. Certainly, as you mentioned, Lori, she has the power to do great balls. She will today. For Jordan Chiles, again, just do what you've been doing. She is as good as she's ever been on vault in the qualifications, and if they just can get a carbon copy of that, my opinion is they will go 1-2 again.
Which will be one, which will be... What's gold, what's silver?
Oh, I suppose that's what we're here to find out. I also spoke with Chelsea Memel yesterday. She mentioned that team finals was fantastic. Some little things off here and there, but finished strong on floor for all-around finals. Proud of Shailese putting together the competition that she knows she's capable of. So it's always fun hearing when your coach, your coordinators, everyone starts speaking in a way that is positive and optimistic about where the team is going to go.
There's that dynamic, too. Your teammates, and you just competed in a team final. Jordan Chiles did not make the individual all-around. She was 12th, had some problems on beam, and there's that two-athlete-per-country rule, so was not able to compete there. But now they're competing against each other. Now you're a competitor, not a teammate out here.
They sure are. But from what I recognize, they're just excited to be out there. You know, we see all these TV shows with a rivalry between gymnastics competitors. And sure, this is a competition. We don't want to forget that. But at the same time, we will notice that they're rooting for each other.
So it will be the 21-year-old from Vancouver, Washington, up first. Really good in the team final in all four of her routines. And a sixth straight world team title for the USA women. Here is Jordan Chiles.
Tango double full for Jordan Chiles. Almost a stuck landing. Her feet are together. She's tied in the air. What more could you ask for? As John mentioned earlier, I think Jordan is her strongest on vault now than she's ever been.
Ho-hum. I mean, she's not out of breath. It was like, yeah, I do that. I can do this.
She finished, took a hop off, and said, all right, time for the next.
Yeah. Come on, hurry up with the score.
It's almost like if she could check her own little watch on her wrist, she would. Are we done?
Exactly.
Look at that height. Everything almost perfectly in line. We watch in slow motion, and of course in slow motion you can see more deductions. Little feet coming apart right there. But overall, she lands pretty much directly in the center. She takes one hop back. I mean, I don't really know what more you could ask for.
And the two Americans, too, back to what we were talking about. Now, they're still young. She's 21. Jade Carey's 22. But go compete in college, UCLA, Jade Carey, Oregon State. Come back to the elite level. Much more often we're seeing that, and it's pretty impressive.
Yeah.
It's completely and Wong.
As we mentioned earlier, for people like Elizabeth Seitz, Ellie Black, competing in older age. We also have Jordan and Jade paving the way for those who go to college and want to come back into the elite scene. Here's Jordan's second vault. Wow, really powerful entrance. Putting her hands down on that mat, the way she enters onto the vault table and then springs right off. You can snap your fingers and she's off the table quicker than that. Once again, those landings matters. And she almost stuck that. I'm expecting a very high score for Jordan Chiles.
The aftermath, again, is like she could just keep doing this for about a half hour. Oh, you want me to do it again? Okay, I'll do it again.
You know what? In practicing with Jordan, that's exactly how she is, too. She's like, oh, another one? Sure. Oh, another one? Yeah, no worries. Oh, another.
That's the sense you get.
I'm curious to know what score she's going to get in comparison for podium. John, what are your thoughts? Where do you think she'll land?
Well, she's going to be in the lead. There's no doubt about it. I mean, that was an exceptional vault, and I think better than she did in qualifications, honestly.
See that clap at the end? She's very excited about that. Listen, if I could do those vaults, I would be proud of that, too.
Okay.
No, she's got a second one. Okay, so another interesting thing is Shylee's jump. Here's her score. Vault 2.
Number one.
14.2.
There it is. 14.35 is the average. So she takes over that top spot.
Let's go, Jade. You got this.
Colleen Deviar Francis, congratulations. World Vault Silver Medalist wants the gold medal this time around. Jade Carey.
This is the hardest vault in the competition, difficulty-wise. And Jade almost sticks it. I did recognize some foot separation off the table, but the difficulty is probably going to trump that.
Top qualifier for this final. And as John said early to start this show, a bit of a motivation, too, that what happened at the Olympics in vault. Now, she came back, obviously, and won the floor gold medalist at the Olympics, but that's still somewhat in her mind.
Yeah, the adrenaline that you can feel before competing really does translate into how fast you run, how hard you can block off the table. When I say block, I mean right there when your hands leave the table. And so if you use that nervous energy to run faster, there's a good chance you may mess up because you don't train like that. Once again, we saw that from Wittenberg. We saw that from Andrade. And unfortunately, we did see that from Jade in Tokyo. But here, so far that first vault looks great. She can hit the second one. Once again, I believe Team USA for Women's Artistic Vault is going to be on the podium. Jordan, no doubt in my mind.
Jordan, obviously, big influence has been Simone Biles and her coaches, too, working there. Jade, coached by her dad, Brian. 14.733.
one execution once again. Always a joy to see a 9 on the execution scoreboard.
Second ball coming up.
Chanko double full, very clean for Jade Carey. I do wonder, first and second between Jade and Jordan, I believe her difficulty for Jade's sake may bring her up a bit higher.
The number for Jordan Chiles, 14-3-5. That's the number that leads. It's the average between the two vaults, so we'll see. Mentioned 2019 when the U.S. last had two women on the podium in the vault final.
This replay. Very tight twisting off the table. Bit of a pipe down. Let's watch her head. Very tight. She spots the landing. John, I'd love to bring you in.
Yeah, you know, she scored a 14.366 on that vault in the qualification round. She needs a little over a 14, a 14.033 to tie Jordan Chiles. You know what? I'm just going to tell you right now, she's going to get it.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
It's going to happen. Not to ruin the suspense, but because we don't know officially, but yeah, it seems like it is. It was Simone Biles, Jade Carey on the podium together, gold, silver in 2019. The last time that happened, 14-3 is the number. 14-5-1-6 in the first place, Jade Carey.
That's got to be so exciting.
Jordan thinks so.
Jordan thinks so. Once again, what I mentioned earlier, Jordan is a team player. She wants everybody to do well. Just like Ellie Black, she mimics the teamwork, the camaraderie. Having a team leader like that is so important.
Lisa Vallon from Belgium. Up next, the 8th qualifier for vault.
I saw a couple form breaks on that vault and a pike down landing. You want to land as straight as you can with your body, as if you were just standing. So to pike your hips at an angle, that is going to be a deduction.
Lisa competing at her first world championship. She's 18. She was in Tokyo for the Olympics.
There are some leg form breaks here. We see a foot separation, bit of bent legs off the table. We'll be able to see it better from this angle. Right there. But once again, I still want to recognize the fact that all of these athletes here are in a world championship vault final. That means right now in this present moment, you are some of the handful of the best in the world.
Yeah, just the accomplishment of getting to the final. I mean, that's
exactly.
The first goal is to have a chance to get there.
Yes.
And they've done that.
I was mentioning earlier, you know, to be able to do two vaults from two different families. And by families, I mean the way you enter onto the table. You have to give all these athletes kudos for that. We watch, you know, athletes like Shailese Jones, who we'll see on the uneven bars pretty soon. She only competed one vault, and her Yurchenko double full is monster, but because she doesn't have two vaults from different families, she's not here.
So the second vault coming up. 14.2 and change. That's ahead of the VR from France, but this one will count as well.
She's got a smile. That could be the smile of relief.
That vault had the lowest start value of anybody in the finals. So just to remind you of the numbers, third place right now, Colleen WR of France, 14.166 is the number. With one gymnast left, Shoko Miyata from Japan.
according to their code of points order.
John, what are your thoughts on our last vaulter coming up?
You know, she's got to work it out for her a little bit to get on that podium. She's got a 5.0 and a 4.8 start value, so the max is 4, obviously 15 and 14.8. She's got to be really clean. She could do it. Got to be really clean, though. Best performance for her on vault since she's been here in Liverpool is what it's going to take.
There's always that tension of waiting for the score. Her second vault, she got a 13.2. Her average, 13.733, landing her in fifth place. Once again, that is fifth in the world right now.
Yeah.
Just for context.
Two Americans, top two spots, and then Deviar trying to be the first gymnast from France since 2009 to make it to the podium in this event. One more to go. Year-old Choko Miyata from Japan qualified seventh, finished eighth in the all-around final on Thursday.
I thought that was quite pretty. She did have a leg separation towards the end, but overall, that was very clean. Beautiful Yurchenko double full. No better feeling than doing that first vault. Smiling, knowing you did a good job, and then having to shut that down a little bit to get ready for your
go back
next.
To work.
Yeah. Again, small leg separation, but overall very clean. We do see a bit of a break onto the table, which will cost her a few tenths. See right here, these closed shoulders right there. The straighter your arms are on the table, the higher you block, the more height you get, the more distance, and that's what we're looking for from vault.
Part of the team effort for Japan on vault, this event, beam and floor. They were in a position, they had a chance to win a bronze medal and then really struggled late on bars. They ended up seventh. The team event.
Liverpool, just a reminder, please no flash photography and no distracting to our gymnastics. Turn or flash off on your phone or camera.
So true, Busty. We heard in the background, shut off flash photography.
Yeah,
that's the worst.
14.066, so not going to challenge those numbers at the top. And Jake Carey kind of realizing, Jordan Childs realizing, this should be the top two. But cheering for her, nonetheless, right now.
Almost a stuck landing. For Choko, I would be very proud of those two vaults. Those were clean, they were hit, and under pressure, she showed up. And that matters. Look at that.
That feeling when you did what you came to do. Yeah, you did your vault, you took care of business, and it's out of your hands now.
Exactly. You put it into the context of these athletes have been going for decades. They've been training since they were little kids, and to show up at a world championship and to hit the vault that you have been training hours and days and years to finally master. Her smiles and her laughs, those are, you know, that is just pure joy and pure relief.
Hey, big picture, is there a moment like for you at the Olympics when you stood there and took it all in and realized I've arrived?
Actually, yeah, there's this moment where you're walking out right before the first event, especially for team finals, because that's when it feels real. You're standing there in your leotard and the judges are just smiling at you because you're all getting ready to go, and then you hear the chime go off in the arena that it's time to start.
Like,
and
I'm
it's like
here.
Oh,
I made it.
Uh-oh. Yeah. My way of grounding was looking around. Oh, here, we've got her scores.
So the number now, 13.999, fifth place. Obviously not going to challenge those on the podium. So it is two Americans in the top two spots of the podium. Jade Carey, the gold medalist. Jordan Childs, the silver. Colleen Deviar from France, the bronze medal.
We're seeing lots of tears for Colleen. Getting on that third place podium for France. How exciting is that?
So Colleen Daviaud, the first athlete from France in this event to make it to the podium since the bronze back in 2009. But the Americans, they own the top two spots. They'll be standing on that podium, Jade Carey and Jordan Chiles, the top two here in the women's vault.
John, do you have any thoughts for us overall?
You know, they came in and did what they did in qualifications. Chelsea Memel, she was prophetic. He said, do what you've done so far, do your normal. That's become their normal, and normal for Team USA on vault. Gold and silver, impressive.
2019, Simone and Jade Carey, the top two. And now it's Jade Carey and Jordan Chiles. Gold and silver for the U.S. Daviaud from France, the bronze medal just ahead of Ellie Black of Canada. So we had the men's floor exercise and the women's vault. Two of the five apparatus finals here on tap today. And stick around at the medal ceremony for those two as we continue with our coverage of the 51st edition of the World Gymnastics Championships. Great start to great break today. This place went nuts. We'll continue our coverage in a moment. Back with our coverage of the World Gymnastics Championships taking place in Liverpool. So two event finals in the books, three more to come. Men's pommel horse, uneven bars for the women, and then the men finish up on still rings. But first two, men's floor, women's vault, the medal ceremony about to get underway.
And then with that, obviously you need to be able to do that multiple times. It's not just about the one-off that you've seen here today. They need to obviously build that volume up in training. Maybe do that for 5, 6, 10 times perhaps in a training session, just to make sure that they've got that muscular endurance as well. So as I say, it's, you know, very technical. It's obviously very demanding on the body as well. Not just the impact of the vault time, but also the forces that does for the body on the landing as well. So just absolute normal strength from the vaulters that they perform today.
Yeah, it really was great, and it's only the top eight that make these individual apparatus finals, so it's just a huge, huge achievement to just be out here representing your country in an apparatus final. Liverpool, we are just moments away from our first presentation here, so stay in your seats or quickly grab your snacks and get ready to cheer on our medal winners so far. We hope you're enjoying it. Are you enjoying it? That's what we like to hear. We'll be back shortly.
Check your pockets.
What do you mean?
Well, that's where he might be. You can't find something.
Ceremony for the men's floor final is about to commence. Please welcome our medalists and presentation party into the arena. International Gymnastics Federation. Presenting silver medal, Andrew Toombs, Men's Artistic Gymnastics Technical Committee Vice President. And presenting bronze medal, Councillor Roy Gladden, Lord Mayor of Liverpool. In third place, and winner of the bronze medal, representing Japan, Ryosuke Doi. In second place, and winner of the silver medal, representing Japan, Daiki Hashimoto. For those who can, please now stand for the national anthem of Great Britain. about to commence. Please welcome our medalists and presentation party into the arena. United States of America.
Three more individual events still to come today from the World Gymnastics Championships taking place in Liverpool. Men's pommel horse up next. And Steven Nedorozic, who is the reigning world champion. Last year when he won that world championship on pommel, it was the first ever world title for the U.S. in this event at Worlds. So this lineup, just a thought to follow up on what you were talking about earlier, just to make it to the final is an achievement at the World Championships.
Exactly. When we look at this list of athletes that are here right now, this tells us that these handful of athletes are the best in the world in this very moment. That is such a high achievement.
Biggest stage, biggest annual event in gymnastics, and Steven Nedorozic won it last year, trying to go back-to-back. With more on him, here's John.
For Steven Nedorozic, these world championships have been a tale of two routines, the joy of the qualification round and the disappointment of the team finals. I spoke with his coach, Randy Jepson, yesterday, and he said over the last couple days of training, Steven has been zeroing in on his mental game and also refining the details of his routine. I've also been told that since Steven got here to Liverpool, he's been unbelievably methodical and consistent in training. He's going to have to show that here today. A couple days ago, Steven posted on social media about the team as they were leaving the team finals. He said, "You could see the look of not only regret, but vengeance in each of our eyes." He went on to say, "It's time to show them what Team USA is made of." He'll have that chance today.
John, thanks. And it wasn't obvious. It wasn't like a fall or a glaring. There were things left out in that routine in the team final, which didn't gain him as many points as he normally does. And in the end, you're left feeling as an athlete like, if I would have just done what I can do, we would have made the podium. So coming back in the individual apparatus final, trying to win the gold medal once again. But get underway when we continue with the action from Liverpool. Great action from the World Gymnastics Championships all week. It continues over the weekend. We're getting set for the men's pommel horse final. Glad to have you with us, Terry Gannon, alongside Lori Hernandez. Great to have her in the booth here, one of the stars from Rio in the Olympics in 2016. And John Roethlisberger, the four-time U.S. champ, who's competed at the World Championships six times. Now he talks for a living, and we've got him there in Liverpool with us as we get set for the eight finalists in men's pommel horse, including the 23-year-old from Worcester, Mass., Steven Nedorozic. Those glasses, by the way, I love this story. It was kind of a hazing thing. An upperclassman in college, they made him wear, and he really performed great. He said, "I'm going to keep wearing them. They're not real.
Like, they're not prescription glasses." Yeah, yeah, he mentioned he started wearing them at a competition, did really well at that competition, and now these glasses are a superstitious event.
And it's a look. There's no doubt.
It's a look.
Great.
He stands out.
Man whose personal record solving Rubik's Cubes, 8.686 seconds.
From what I understand, though, Steven does wear glasses.
Which is not like this on the pommel.
These are not prescription glasses.
Exactly.
But he has mentioned he just needs to feel it. He doesn't need to see it. So I think that's an interesting concept.
Yosuke Doi from Japan. Busy man. We saw him earlier in the floor final and had the lead for a while, but it was Regina Moran of Great Britain winning the gold medal there. So the second event for the men as they continue the warm-ups here and pommel horse. Ron de Bon from the Netherlands qualified in fourth for this final, the European silver medalist on pommel horse this past year. Such a long season. I mean, yes, you take time off at different points in the year, but I mean, does fatigue come into play at this point, especially this week, too? You started training, qualifying, team, now individual.
Absolutely, especially when you're waiting around all this time. You know, we had just seen floor finalists. We've now seen women's vault finalists, and we're on pommel. So these athletes have been waiting around all day. Of course, they're stretching and whatnot, but this moment to get warm and to retrain your body, wake up that muscle memory, it's quite exhausting.
Does it affect you where you are in the start list?
Yes, I personally believe so, yes. To come in first, you have to warm up quickly and then take the time to breathe, gather your thoughts, let your body rest for a moment before you get back out there and start competing. Whereas if you're last, you can take more warm-up turns. At that point, you have all the time in the world.
Because we talked about your routine. You said it's pretty set. You had a set routine. Well, it's different if you're first or eighth in the lineup.
Exactly. Yes. And to come in first, you're starting this group off. You're kicking them off. So if athletes in your group are watching you, who are the domino effect, you know?
Then Arazic, by the way, will be the fourth up in this pommel horse final. John, you've been close to the athletes and those training them, in charge of them throughout the week. Some thoughts as we get closer to this final getting underway.
Well, personally, pommel horse final is my favorite final. I think there's something about the perfection of pommel horse that is so appealing to watch. But just to get to the athletes, Ned Arosik has had tremendous training here. We saw him just warm up. The mistake he made in the team competition wasn't a fall from the apparatus. He left out a couple of skills. Actually started 1.3 points lower in his start value. So I don't suspect he's going to make that mistake today. Really, today it's going to come down to all those small errors the athletes make. And to be honest with you, if you're watching at home, a lot of those errors aren't going to be the obvious ones that we can see. They're going to be the little idiosyncrasies that only really the judges can pick up. It's going to be that fine deductions that will make the difference today. It's going to be fun.
Laurent Dumont will be the first man out there to get things going here in the pommel horse final.
He qualified fourth on the pommel horse. So if he can be clean, you never know where he may end up. Let's see if he can get that podium score.
23 years of age, representing the Netherlands. Did not qualify for the final at the World Championships last year.
He was the 2022 European silver medalist on pommel horse, so this is interesting. From their hips to the pommel, the better the execution.
Oh, wow. To the very end, Lauren. John, almost, and then no.
I mean, I was watching this routine thinking to myself, this is a marathon routine, and the dismount, it showed exactly that. He just lost a little steam, and I have been there. Trust me, I've been there many times in practice and in competition. You get to the end of a long routine, and it is all just about will. Your arms are burning. You just dig deep to try to get that handstand up, and I got to give him credit. He was going for the win here. He wasn't going to just get on the podium. He was going for gold.
In your mind as an athlete, Lori, you've done all that work. There's just this much more to go, and it falters.
Oh, it's heartbreaking. Exactly what it looks like, this feeling of your heart breaking because you worked so hard to be here. But at the same time, what John had mentioned earlier, and I'd love to cue him back in on this, he did everything he could. He put out the difficulty. He showed up for Worlds. He didn't play it safe. There's something to be said for that.
Yeah, and really, I mean, visually, the routine was really good. The judges certainly had deductions for things like skew, and that means the athlete has to be perfectly square to the horse when they travel, things like that, but no form breaks really to be noticed. And again, it was going through my head as I watched him go for that last travel near the end of the routine before the dismount, and I thought, my gosh, this is a marathon. Unfortunately, today it didn't pay off.
You know, the other aspect, too, just watching it, the crowd, the noise grew and grew.
Yes.
And grew up until that very point.
Yeah, you could hear his teammates, but also just people from all over the country, you know, who are in this group competing in individual finals, cheering for him.
So the number 13533, Laurent Dumont from the Netherlands, gets things started in the pommel horse final. Next up, a man who's been awfully busy. We watched him in the floor final. Yosuke Doi, 20 years of age. That's it, from Okayama, Japan. qualified sixth for this final. Visualizing, going through his whole routine. Back to back, one side to another.
They say every time you run a mental routine, it's like your body's physically doing it. It's almost like he was getting one more rep in.
Skill, believe it or not, and his shoulders just got too far outside the plane of the pommel horse. And Lori, you can probably attest to this on balance beam. I think it's very similar. He was on. He was perfect, and then he wasn't. And that is how brutal pommel horse can be.
There does come a point where you tilt off the equipment, and it's this question of, can you save it? Can you? Sometimes you're just off. Got a little leg separation there. John, what are your thoughts?
Yeah, that's just, it's too bad. You know, we've already had two routines, two falls, but, and he looked good. Even if he hits and the top guys hit as well as they can, do I think he's going to win gold? No, but the way this pommel horse final has started, certainly he would have given himself a chance for a medal, so too bad for him. Little rough on that scissor sequence. You know, that first scissor to handstand, that is a skill that Asher Hong, for example, does that skill. Took it out because of how strictly it's evaluated. The judges almost always will take at least 3/10 deduction on that skill. The rest of the circles in his travels, very nice extension. His toe point was excellent. This right here, though, the Wu, as it's called, after a Chinese gymnast. Shoulders just get too far outside of the horse. And I know that exact feeling, actually. Fallen many times on that skill.
You've said that twice now. You brought that up twice now. You had a lot of success, you know. 12-9-3-3.
I forgot.
Yeah, I conveniently forgot. So into second place after two and falls on both. But the top two qualifiers next, back to back. Reese McLennan representing Ireland, the 23-year-old and the world bronze medalist on pommel horse from 2019.
Starting off with a difficult sequence. Right on one pommel. Ooh. Staying on just one pommel is extremely difficult. He's known as the Prince of Pommel.
And something's just looked
cool.
Such
little space for his hands just then.
Yep.
Incredible routine for Reese McLennan.
Absolutely unbelievable routine. You can see the emotion on his face. He knows that this is a title he has wanted for a long time. Fell short at the Olympics in Tokyo, but I watched him in training and qualifications, and I thought, if Steven Nedorozov wants to repeat, he has got a big task ahead of him. They start at a similar position in start value, but Reese's execution, I have to give him the edge, and you can see it throughout. Maybe a slight hip bend on that scissor to handstand, which would be a deduction, but then look out, he just flies.
saw the exchange between the two as Nedorozic is up next. Shake of the hand, but basically say, good luck after that.
Oh, yeah. But also, you know, watching that sense of pride and relief. I keep saying that because it truly is a sense of relief, this pressure lifted when you do the routine that you have been training for so long and it finally pays off. That was a difficult routine. I had my heart in my throat and in my stomach watching him the entire time.
You're on the edge of your seat every moment,
yeah.
Aren't you? As it builds, sensational. Top qualifier. Nedorozic qualified second. So the top two to get here at least going back to back. But we'll get the number for Reese McLennan in a moment. Seventh in Tokyo after that bronze at Worlds in 2019.
Yeah, they both actually scored the same score in the qualifications, Reese McLennan and Steven Nedorozic, but Reese got the tiebreaker. But I tell you what, Steven is going to have to do better today than he did in the qualifications, in my opinion, if he wants to finish on the top again. He got a 15.233. This routine that Reese just did, I think, is better than that number. So Steven obviously had some troubles in the team finals. Hopefully he's gotten those corrected and then some, because I think this is going to have to be the best Steven Nedorozic has ever been.
But do you press? I mean, that you put that pressure on yourself to even better, be better than what you've done so far.
I'm feeling the pressure through the screen right now. So I can't imagine what Steven's feeling. Also knowing that you have such incredible competitors in your group.
15.3, the number. Reese McLennan from Ireland on top.
Almost a 9.0 execution score. That's wow. Just wow.
Wow, indeed. So it's a high number, the standard that has been set for the American now, trying to go back-to-back, the last American to go back-to-back with gold medals in any event at the World Championships. Kurt Thomas back in 79. Steven Nedorozic trying to do just that.
He stays here on one pommel, very difficult. Little break in momentum there and in the hips. That's a hit routine for Steven Nedorozic.
I tell you what, I was watching the beginning of this routine, and in my head, I was getting the words ready to say, that is the best I've ever seen Steven Nedorozic. And then he got to that one pommel. I'm sure we'll have a chance to look at it again. He had that big hip bend as he went back to the middle, and he lost some difficulty. I hate to say it, but this is not going to be enough to pass Reese McLennan.
And we're seeing some of the difficulty there. When he won that world title last year, it was the first one ever won by the U.S. in this event. And McLennan was absolutely brilliant.
Here's the mistake right here. You see his hip bend, and he goes all the way back to the pommel there. He was supposed to stay on the one pommel, but he went back to the middle. So I believe that is going to lower his start value, not to mention the judges take deductions when something looks perfect. If you can see a visible break, they're wearing out their pencil, I'll be honest with you. So that's going to hurt.
Again, you've been there.
Yes.
Yeah.
We all have, yeah.
So 15.3 is the number that leads right now. Very high number. No, not going to get there. 14.4 for Steven Nedorozic, the 23-year-old who's second on the leaderboard now. McLennan still leads and that might hold up. We'll see. So four gymnasts to have gone here on Pommel Horse. We've got four more to go. And that will be tough to beat. So 2019 was the first medal for Ireland. It was Rhys McLennan who won bronze. If he wins the gold here, it will be Ireland's first.
We're getting lots of firsts in this world championship this year. How exciting.
So you got four more to go, John.
Yeah, we do. We've got some great athletes yet to come up. And actually, the one I'm really curious to watch is going to be the next gymnast, Kurbanov from Kazakhstan. He has got, even amongst the best people who swing pommel horse, he has got a swing that, to me, really stands out. I'd like to see if he can put together a clean routine. He's supposed to start, and I say supposed to because, as we know, start values change in the middle of a routine. He's supposed to start at the same start value as Rhys McLennan. So if he can just be a little cleaner, do those little things throughout his routine. We're talking about this is going to be decided if he hits. It'll be decided by less than a tenth, but he's one that could do it. I'm looking forward to seeing him.
You know how close it is as a competitor, but you expect that at the World Championships. You expect your competitors to be excellent.
You do, and we hear this a lot, but every tenth matters of leg separation, a hop on the landing, a wobble if you're on beam, or a hip break on pommels. Those things really do add up, and when it comes to such a close score, you don't want to give up a mistake like that, especially on such a high platform like World Championships.
Dinyan would be the last to go from Armenia. So the last warm-up right now underway before the final four are set. Just the number, John, not just the performance, but that number. If you're a competitor right now, one of the last four looking up at 15-3, what are you thinking?
Well, I'm doing what Lori said earlier, is I'm not looking. I'm not. And as we talk about in gymnastics all the time, there is no defense. There's nothing you can do to affect the other athlete. All you have is your gymnastics and doing it as well as you can. And Chelsea Memel, really, she's been saying it all week, do your normal. And it sounds boring. Media doesn't like to hear that, right? We want to hear, I'm going to go, you know, kick tail and win this meet. But that's the truth about gymnastics. You got to just be who you are. Be the best version of you if you want to give yourself a chance.
In sports where there is no tackling or defending like a basketball guard, I mean, that's all you can do. The process and take care of your own business that you came to do.
And when you're competing and you're giving all this energy to yourself, not paying attention to what other people are doing, that's a lot of times when we see the best performances.
Nariman Kurbanov, as John mentioned, the 24-year-old from Kazakhstan. He'll be the first of the four left. He qualified in third.
His long lines and legs were practically built for pommel horse. Ooh, he's got a form break right there. Bent legs, leg separation.
Perfect job.
Oh, that was a heartbreaking mistake. And you guys can see what I was talking about. His swing, he's got such great amplitude, and his body type is so built for pommel horse, those long, lean legs, and it just looks so good on the apparatus. But again, I told you it had to be visually perfect. Not that it would get a perfect score, but a break like that with the bent legs, hitting the horse, spreading your legs apart, that's going to be the difference, unfortunately. Now, the way pommel horse finals is going, I wouldn't count him out for a medal yet, because everybody seems to be making mistakes, but unfortunately the gold's not going to happen.
Third place right now is 13-5-3-3. DeMont just behind Medarazic. McLennan leads it with that number of 15-3.
And
Lori, once you start, there's no turning back.
Oh, yeah. There is no turning back. As soon as you salute those judges and you touch the equipment, it's game time. A lot of times my body would just take over.
Oh, he's ahead of Nedorozic, 14-5-3-3. So into second place, Kurbanov from Kazakhstan. As McLennan still leads. Nobody has challenged that number yet.
So Reese do a little sigh of relief there. So I'm still in first.
Ahmed Abu Al-Soud, 27-year-old from Jordan on Pommel now, qualified in eighth.
That 360 on one hand is very difficult.
Loves it. He loves it. Well, the judges love it.
The coaches love it.
Does John love it?
I love it. That was amazing. That was absolutely the opportunity this man has been waiting for. You look back at the history of his gymnastics, clearly a good pommel horse worker, but his first experiences internationally were not good. Finished in the hundreds on this event, but slowly and methodically has worked his way up and given himself a chance here at the Worlds, and now taking advantage maybe of some of the medal favorites. And right now that looks to me like a medal performance. I don't know that it's going to be good enough to overtake Reese. I don't think it will be, but he's going to be right in there for silver or bronze. Outstanding.
27-year-old in his fourth appearance at the World Championships and the first time that he has qualified for a final. Look at his coaches before he's even done.
The coaches always know. You could be midair and the coach is like, oh, no. Or they're like, oh, yeah.
Right.
I love watching their reactions.
No athlete from Jordan has ever made the podium at the World Gymnastics Championships. Ahmed Abu Al-Soud could be the first. Look at this. 14-8-6-6 into second place. And you've got two gymnasts left, John.
Yeah, Philippe Houdet is going to be the next man up, and he is similar to Ossenberger from France on floor. He has the lowest start value in this final, so he's the guy that's going to have to be uber perfect. Just starts at a 15.8, and so to only lose a point on an event, especially pommel horse, is very unusual. So, again, he's going to have to be as good as he's ever been to get on the podium, in my opinion.
36 years old, the first Croatian gymnast to win an Olympic medal, a silver in 2008.
Separation there. Happened right as I was about to say his feet are glued together. Oh.
Not quite at the end. Three-time Olympian, 2008, 2012, 2016. Veteran right to the very end, couldn't quite get there.
Yeah, unfortunately, that's going to kill his medal chances. And he saw the break in the middle. Honestly, that was a heck of a save when he was in between those pommels. Just to stay on the pommel horse. I wanted to say yee-haw. He was swinging so fast. That was an amazing save. Unfortunately, couldn't keep it together there at the end.
Yee-haw.
Quite a career, though.
They always say yee-haw, but they never ask. call you.
That's a new one. I'm going to write that down.
Thank you so much. I stole it from Twitter.
World Silver.
I'm taking notes as we speak.
Yeah, exactly, Jack.
I can feel this guy's bones as he's up there swinging. You know, I was around the sport for a long time. I don't want to say how old I was, but it's hard to keep at a high level in this sport for as long as Philippe has. He's already been to 3 Olympics. I assume he's going to try for a 4th. So pretty amazing to be able to keep this level of gymnastics over that span of time, certainly.
I'm really quite glad you mentioned that, actually, because with time, we know that the code of points is constantly changing and skills are getting more and more difficult as the generations come by. So to bring a lot of kudos to those who have previously been to Olympic Games or previously been to World Championships and are still sticking around for these code of points to change, you know, not only are the skills changing, but these athletes are changing with that.
Well, he's won silver at the big events. He said, I want to stick around until I win gold at one of the major events. Not going to get there today. 12-5, the number. And we have one gymnast left. McLennan still with the lead. Yeah, both medalists right there. Haroutyun Erdinyan from Armenia. A 38-year-old. So you got veterans here, a 36-year-old, a 38-year-old. He qualified 5th. He was 8th in this event last year at the Worlds. He's won a bronze medal.
This is absolutely an incredible performance, and I know the million-dollar question is, was that good enough to take over the gold medal spot? And I'll tell you what, it should not be good enough. He did have the extension to me and the execution that McLennan did from Ireland. However, it's like going in to the ice cream shop. I love mint chocolate chip. Somebody else likes vanilla. And if you let the judges decide what flavor ice cream they like best, they might pick the flavor you don't agree with. And that might be the situation we're in. But I really do think he had enough of an execution difference that he'll probably drop in that second spot.
That was my follow-up question. But you do think he'll make it to the podium. It seemed like a podium routine.
Yeah, I gotta say, I had no idea where that analogy was going, but that was extremely helpful in discovering where this routine places in amongst everybody else.
15 points.
You just gotta hang in there with me for a while.
15.3 is the number, the top number. That second spot's 14.866, and then you're wanting at least that third spot to be on the podium. 14.533 is that third number. That's going to get there to the podium at least. 14.733. It's a bronze. Erdinyan for Armenia will make it to the podium. How about Ahmed Abu Alsouk from Jordan? Their first medal at the World Championships, a silver. And Maurice McLennan from Ireland, the first gold for Ireland in this event at Worlds.
I tell you what's amazing about this final is look at the countries on the podium. We see so much about Japan and China and Britain and the United States, especially on the men's side. We have Ireland, Jordan, and Armenia, and Kazakhstan are the top 4 countries on pommel horse, which I think is really a testament to how vast and broad the sport is spreading throughout the world. Pretty amazing.
It is amazing. 0.2 of a point is what separated 3rd from 4th. Erdinyan and Kurbanov. And so that man will celebrate with a silver medal, Ahmed Abu Alsouk.
And it's like from anyone who's watching right now, you get to just watch this moment happen. You get to watch it unfold and recognize that It doesn't matter who you are or where you're from, you have the capabilities to do anything. And we see that by all the color we see on stage.
And no matter where you qualified, whether it's eighth or first,
exactly,
to get to the final. Adinian at the age of 38, it's a bronze medal. They won a world bronze on Pommel back in 2015. Makes it there again. But it's Ireland celebrating with the gold medal. Grace McLennan, the 23-year-old who won the bronze in 2019. It was Ireland's first, now the first gold. Ahmed Abu Al-Soud from Jordan, the silver. Adinian from Armenia, the bronze. Much more to come as the World Championships continue from Liverpool. Football final. Right now, though, it's all about the World Gymnastics Championships and three events in the books today, two more to come. How about the finish here? Men's pommel horse, Rhys McLennan from Ireland. John, he was so impressive.
No question, he was the best. And to Rhys, this is a long time coming. This is something that this young man has wanted. He's been passionate about it. It's a dream of his. It's great to see him happen. Keep in mind, this is a guy that trained in his backyard garden on a pommel horse because he couldn't find a place to train not all that long ago. And here he is, the world champ.
We're all going to be building pommel horse in our backyards to practice from this point forward.
Yeah, I will build us one. We can do it.
I'm going to hold you to that. I'll come over and practice in the backyard. How about Steven Nedorozic, John, and what you saw from him?
Yeah, Steven, it is an opportunity lost, honestly. You know, he had a break, and he knows it. Unfortunate for him, but I think today was Reese's day. If he had hit really well, if he had hit perfect, he would have been right there, but I don't know if he could have got that gold medal spot. It was a pretty special day for Reese, but Steven, we'll see him again. He's a special young man in himself.
Tall order to get to that 15-3 number. You see nobody really close to that number put up by Rhys McLennan. So move from one to the next. Women's uneven bars. And Shailese Jones, the 20-year-old from Seattle, part of the mix here. And is John Roethlisberger with you. John is in Liverpool watching the action, talking to some coaches, athletes, giving his views on what he just saw. How about what we're going to see, Lori? Here is the lineup here. Rebecca Andrade coming off that world all-around title just a few days ago.
Yes, for Team USA today on the uneven bars, we have Shailese Jones. She's going up against Andrade, Said, Sterwile, and other fantastic bar workers. So she's going to need, first off, a hit routine. She needs to make it from start to finish in clean. We know Shailese can get a lot of height, so you want to keep an eye out for that. But Nina Derwal is known for connecting all her skills together, giving us lots of bonus, lots of high start value. So I think everybody's going to give each other a run for their money here.
So besides Shailese Jones and Rebecca Andrade from Brazil, you've got the reigning Olympic champ in Nina Derwal from Belgium and the reigning world champ, Wei Xiaoyuan from China. So this is, I mean, these are the top.
This is quite the lineup here.
Yeah, it's something else. And there's your atmosphere in between. Announcements have been made. I like how they announce now. They come out, it's like the NBA All-Star game or the, I mean, it's pretty good fanfare.
A little bit. You know what? And this is sarcasm. It is really nice for the senses to hear high-level electronic dance music and strobe lights right before you go out and compete. I love it so much.
Get you pumped up as an athlete?
Things.
Yeah. Or as an announcer, I'm not sure what you're talking about.
Oh, as an athlete. As an announcer, I get a blast from watching this. I don't know. It just, you got to stay grounded while this is happening, you know?
What is it like announcing rather than competing? I know the nerves aren't the same, obviously. But
a little different.
a little bit. Experience it from this standpoint, though, as opposed to being out there.
You know, watching is a lot more nerve-wracking than actually doing. I know that when I was competing, there's this feeling of I know what is going to happen next. I know what my intentions are. I know what skills I'm trying to do. But from, you know, I used to hear this from my parents. We watched and we saw you make a mistake. We didn't know it was coming. And I'm like, well, I did. So watching is always nerve-wracking. I always kind of have my fingers crossed that every athlete gets to do the best that they can, especially at a competition like this. Shailese Jones making individual bar finals, though. I mean, this is so exciting. Chelsea Memel mentioned, you know, we really saw her potential, especially at team finals, because she hit all four events. And we know that Shailese has had some consistency issues at high-level competitions. So for her to come here at Worlds and make an individual final, this is a huge accomplishment.
Top names, no doubt, though. Rebeca Andrade from Brazil. That was the first world all-around title for Brazil. She captured that on Thursday. But Shailese Jones, the world all-around silver. Yeah, more on Shailese, John?
Yeah, I talked to Chelsea about Shailese earlier today, actually. And we brought up those consistency issues, Lori, that you had just mentioned. And she talked about how she's been as consistent as she's ever been through this fall from championships on to these world championships. And she really feels like this experience right here has given her so much confidence and just helped her build on that. And she really feels like those issues really could be behind her now. And who knows? I said this at US Classics. And Lori, you're sitting right there. I just want to go back on the record. I said Shailese Jones is going to win a world all-around medal. And she did that. She's got every physical ability to be the best in the world, and I think that is her ceiling.
I would absolutely agree with that. And from what we just saw, even her bar warm-ups, for everyone at home watching, keep an eye out on how high she goes. We see this height from people like Simone Biles when she's on floor, or Michaela Maroney when she's on vault. Shailese Jones is a height, long-distance goddess who's able to go as high as can be. It is mind-blowing, the height that she can get.
Naomi Visser from the Netherlands, 21-year-old, as warm-ups continue.
Yep.
In the all-around at the World Championships in 2021, a couple of days ago, made it to the all-around final and came in 18th. She qualified 7th for this uneven bars final. All right, so when that happens during warm-up, where's your mind go?
Once again, I don't want to speak for everybody, but when that would happen to me, it was good luck. I was notorious for awful warm-ups. My mom always told me it was just me having to get the kinks out. So if I ever fell, it actually made me feel more secure because I was like, oh, I got the fall out of the way. Now it means I'm going to hit. But
we talked about that the other day. You're not the first to say that. A lot of athletes feel that way.
Yeah, you already have so much pressure as it is, so to put pressure on having a perfect warm-up before you compete, the warm-up doesn't matter. You just got to get warm. What matters is if you can hit under pressure. So whatever your body needs to do in that time to reset, take its time, wake up the muscle memory, wake up your brain from having sat in the cold for so long watching other athletes go, it's go time. It's whatever you need. Every warm-up looks different. I was always so wary in that case if I did have a good warm-up. I was like, oh, no.
Right. If it went well, then you're worried. Exactly. Sanne Veerman, another athlete from the Netherlands, just finished warming up.
The more water and chalk you squirt on the bar, the stickier it gets. Feels good on the leather grips. You could stick a landing on floor and on dismounts, but can you stick your hands back to the bar? John, I think sticky feet and sticky landings and making tally marks for every time an athlete does one of those, I think that should count for every release move caught, too.
Yeah, right. Absolutely.
You talk about her stature in the sport. It just grows and grows. I mean, what she did in Tokyo, gold medalist on vault silver, in the individual all-around, and now the world all-around champ as we look ahead to Paris 2024.
World Championships is a very important competition, but it is also a way for the Olympic Committee to check who's at their best right now, who can hit under pressure.
23-year-old from Rio, Rebeca Andrade.
That was a mistake. She was supposed to do a full pirouette there. Uh-oh. What's interesting is that during competition, a lot of athletes will just keep swinging, finish their full pirouette, but she chose to come down and take the 1-point fall. Huh. She goes, starting over. Getting that full connection bonus in. We've seen one skill after the other. That is going to raise her difficulty score. Little close to the bar there. She caught with bent arms. That's a deduction.
So how costly will that opening mistake be?
I think that's going to take quite the bite out of her score. We've got a lot of really incredible bar workers here for today's uneven bar finals at Worlds. So I do worry that that mistake will pull Andrade off the podium.
Yeah, it's going to do more than take a bite. It's over for her medal hopes on this event, unfortunately. That was just a huge error, and too bad. You know, she does, I believe, have a floor final coming up yet, so hopefully an individual medal there. But, you know, here's the thing I wonder is you see these athletes go through qualifications and team finals, and the emotion of winning an all-around gold medal is something I haven't experienced, but I got to think it just is an emotional drain. And honestly, she looked just maybe a little tired.
Yeah, we also recognize that when, you know, for the women's artistic, for everybody, honestly, for every athlete that's here at Worlds right now, you come about a week and a half or so before the actual competition starts, and you train. Some of them twice a day, some once a day, but you are training so you can get used to the time change, get used to the equipment, because all equipment is different across all countries. Some bars, you know, the bars here may be way bouncier than what we're used to at home, so that changes the timing of your release moves. But all of that working out, all of that mental gymnastics, no pun intended, that you have to do, it's going to exhaust you. So to keep the stamina going, especially after team finals is over, it's difficult.
Shailese Jones will be next. Obviously, quite the opportunity now after that major error early on in the routine for Andrade. Started gymnastics when she was 4 years old. Brothers would walk her to and from practice. 12.8 the number, so obviously not what she was looking for.
I can tell you right now that 12.8 is not going to make the podium. She finished really well, though.
20-year-old from Seattle, Shailese Jones. Silver medalist in the all-around, the uneven bars champ from the U.S. Championships in 2022.
Starts off beautiful connections. Watch this height that's coming right here. Right back up to the high bar. Here comes her dismount. Fantastic routine for Shailese Jones. I gotta say, my heart is in my stomach right now.
Teammates, Jordan Childs. John, what do you think?
I'll tell you what, best routine Shailese Jones has done on the uneven bars her entire time in Liverpool, and what a moment to do it. She actually did a sequence she hasn't done here connected since she's been in Liverpool. She did her Tkachev on the high bar, right to the pack salto, the laid out in between the bars, right connected to the Van Leeuwen, where she goes from the low bar back up to the high bar. Chelsea Memel said she might do it if she is on, but she only decides mid-routine if she's going to connect those skills. It adds 1/10 of bonus to her start value, and I also, frankly, think it eliminates some possible execution errors. Big moment for Shailese.
I love watching the arc of being a nervous competitor, making those mistakes, you know, training really well, and then coming to competition and having a couple falls or mistakes, to the arc of showing up at World Championships and hitting every routine you've done so far. Fantastic for Team USA.
It's a couple of World Championships ago, 2019, when the U.S. had a gymnast on the podium in this event. Suni Lee won bronze. Shailese Jones hoping for gold, though, and hoping for a big number right now.
Thank you.
second in the all-around on Thursday. Right behind the athlete who was first up on uneven bars. 14-7-6-6, the number. So in the first place goes Shailese Jones.
Oh, we can hear Chelsea Memel say that was so good. Chelsea Memel is the technical lead of USA Gymnastics. An Olympian herself.
So the announcement for the first of two gymnasts from the Netherlands, Naomi Visser. 21-year-old who qualified seventh.
And she starts the routine, unfortunately, with a fall. Those handstands got to get locked out. You have to stay as tight as can be. If you wobble like that, we call that banana back. If you arch over, you're going to fall. Let's see if she can finish strong. Seeing lots of little mistakes in this routine. Fidgeting hands, leg separations. But a smooth ending. Unfortunately, that fall is gonna cost her a podium medal.
So three gymnasts have gone in uneven bars. We had early mistakes, two of the three, not Shailese Jones.
Difficult combination to catch a release with your hands crossed, one in front of the other, and then come and do a pack salto to the low bar while spinning. What's important to acknowledge, and we mentioned this earlier, is that for the uneven bars right now, these athletes have been sitting in the cold gym for a few hours now. We've seen the men go on floor, women on vault, men on pommels, and now they're on bars. And then they only get 30 seconds to warm up their routine. So to hit with cold muscles is next level.
And there were early mistakes for both she and Rebecca Andrade. So one more to go before another warm-up, and then four more after that. And among those four still to come, after Sanne Veerman from the Netherlands, you've got the reigning Olympic champ and the reigning world champ. See if that number holds up for Shailese Jones. Mentioned the bronze by Suni Lee in 2019 for the United States. Last gold was 2015, Madison Kosher. So it's been a while since an athlete from the U.S. won gold on this. And you got the number from Visser ahead of Andrade, but Shailese Jones still solid lead. Son of Airman from the Netherlands up next. 20 years of age, competing in her second world championships, the first time that she has qualified for a final.
I'm seeing some form breaks. We've got a little bit bent legs on those releases. That was beautiful. Foot separation there. For something. I unfortunately think she had quite a handful of form breaks that the judges are going to be able to pinpoint and dock her for. John.
Yeah, I'm about 10 feet away from the Dutch broadcasters. We're at the same table here in the venue. And I got to say, after Naomi Visser had her mistake on that bar routine, they were loving this one. They were giving her an applause.
No Dutch gymnast has made the podium at the World Championships in this event since 2001.
A year after I was born.
Stop. Stop. I don't want to hear that.
Was just a little one.
You've come a long way.
In that pack full, I did see a leg separation in between. And just some loose, we call them loose knees. So not quite bent, not quite straight. What we want is to see locked out straight legs. Quite the hop forward on the landing as well, but once again, I can't say it enough. A hit routine is a hit routine, especially under pressure like this.
14.766 is the number for Shailese Jones. You wouldn't expect it to challenge that, but you never know, judges.
You never know.
Yep.
Let's find out.
14.5 and change was her number qualifying. Oh, it's pretty good, though. It's not going to get to the top spot, but 14.166. She nods in agreement. Son of Airman into second place, but it is 20-year-old Shailese Jones from the United States with the lead. It's been quite a world championship, quite a year for her. So we'll have a warm-up here. Shailese with the lead. Airman second, Visser in third, ahead of Rebecca Andraji, the all-around champ. But you've got Seid Sturweil, Wei, and Lo. Two of those four have won gold medals on the biggest stages.
Yeah, I do believe that this next set of athletes is really going to give Shailese quite a push for that score.
John,
they have a great track record.
What do you have, John?
I agree with exactly what Lori just said. I think this is where the rubber hits the road. Can Shailese Jones' score hold up? You have two Chinese. You have Nina Durweil, and then, of course, the veteran, Elizabeth Seitz. But the one thing I want to bring up, and you guys can give me your opinion as we go through the competition, and those at home certainly can have their couch opinion like I would. I take offense to how the judges evaluate the Chinese gymnasts on this event. I'd love to hear Lori's perspective. They have this precision that I think is pretty special. I want to see how it holds up when you go back to back to back. These last three gymnasts, Nina Durweil, and then the two Chinese gymnasts. Those three could easily be the top three on the podium. We'll be able to compare them right next to each other, which I think is really fun.
You know what? I would agree with that. And I think, dare I say, we experiment and we watch these next few routines, and the focus of being clean, tight handstands, all the way up, toes to the ceiling, straight legs, pointed toes. Let's see what this looks like back to back. That's what the judges are looking for.
Nina Durweil warming up. I mean, you saw the bio a moment ago. It's hard to beat. It's Olympic title, a couple of world championships. I mean, she has been for a while among, if not the best. Not every event, obviously. Wei Chao Yan, the world champ this past year, will be part of this last group.
There was one competition I went to where the girls before me were spraying the bars so much, and it was soaked. And then I remembered it was my turn right after. What do I do?
Yeah, that is, I mean, every gymnast wants it a little different than another, and usually as a team you have it similarly.
Exactly.
Done. But when you do find yourself in that situation, it can really throw you off, can it?
It definitely can. It's, you know, the feel of the bars, your hands are the only thing, aside from when you do toe-ons, but for the most part, your hands are the only things that's touching the equipment the entire time. So if you feel like you're going to slip, if you feel like your hands are stuck, that's the worst feeling in the world. You need them to be mobile, but not slippery.
Be pretty good here with Durweil and Wei Chao Yan.
That is quite the spring
model. Yeah, it's big time,
isn't
it?
Wow, that's It's, wow, that's a waterfall.
Lo Rue from China qualified first. So the best in qualifying and the bronze medalist from last year. Yeah, medalists everywhere here in these final four. Shailese Jones waiting to see if she wins a gold.
I gotta say, though, the height on Shai's routine is just, it's unmatched from what I've watched so far. She goes so high.
I thought it was funny. Yes, every time. I noticed, yes.
If I'm not mistaken, they're talking about re-watering, re-chalking the bars every single time. It is quite the system. If that were me, I would call it superstitious.
Yeah. It's part of sports.
Superstitious. Sure is.
Yeah.
And listen, at the end of the day, if it comes down to your hands slipping on bars at world championships, you wet those bars. You suck those bad boys. If that's what's going to help, whether it's mental, physical, both, it doesn't matter. You're here to compete and do the best that you can. So methods, at the end of the day, are not judged.
That's Naomi Visser, who's up there setting up the bars for Elizabeth Seitz.
Some athletes know how other athletes like the bar set as well. Hmm. So, like, there were times where I would agree with one where I was like, oh, I like it this way, or, oh, I wish there was more chalk. And my friends would be like, oh, I'll go chalk it up before you go. I'm not competing.
and then you're competing against her, so you pretend like you're spraying the bar and you don't.
Never.
You would.
That only happens in TV shows.
I see.
One other competition that I was at. But that, no, never.
Final four set. Well, I thought they were set. Still announcing. All right, here we go. She just turned 29 years of age, Elizabeth Seitz from Germany. The final qualifier for the Uneven Bars final. It's her best event. Won a world bronze medal in 2018.
Great connection from Seitz. Beautiful height. You got to give it to her. She is clean. Her feet are together. She locked out that handstand. That was a beautiful handstand. Getting ready for the dismount. That is a hit and stuck routine for Elizabeth Seitz.
Still winning championships. Won the European title on uneven bars in 2022. So this may not be easy holding on to the top spot. We'll see over the course of the next four athletes. Yep.
An amazing finish. Clean finish.
Amazing and clean. The comment?
Amazing and clean. That is a great comment to get from your coach.
Yeah.
This release right back to the low bar. Her feet are glued together. We see her in this perfect arch. I loved it. I thought this was a great routine.
As in threatening the top spot?
I'm not sure about that. I gotta say, I really am curious to know what score they're gonna give her. Every tenth matters. Oh.
Just coming off her birthday yesterday.
29 years old. Love that she and Ellie Black are paving the way for
women's artistic gymnast to keep moving forward and to not stop, whether that's before or after college, but to keep persevering.
Her 10th world championships. It's not good enough for the top spot, but 14-3-6-6. It's close, or at least close enough to get her to second place right now with three gymnasts left. Shailese Jones still with the lead. Always nice to be announced as the reigning Olympic champion. Here is Nina Derweil, who, oh, by the way, has two world championships on uneven bars as well.
What's interesting about her routine, we're seeing lots of connections, one skill after the other, just like that. That is racking up massive bonus points for her score. I gotta say, that was a fantastic routine from Derweil. That's gonna rival Shiley's score. Simply because of difficulty as well.
Time and again, she comes through under pressure. Biggest stages, Nina Derweil, who's just 22 years old, has accomplished a lot already. It really has not competed in over a year.
So she goes right from this skill, crosses her arms right back to the low bar, and then keeps moving right back up to the high bar. And then she connects this to another skill. We missed it, but I believe she went back to the low bar. Incredible is my point. Really,
yeah.
Impressive.
Yeah. It's taken off most of the last year. Skipped the World Championships and the European Championships, the latest version of, and still right there here in the final.
It's interesting that she didn't compete at the 2021 Worlds. But she's here, and she's thriving. And I want to know what her score is.
took some time off, spent time with her family, traveled some, was on Dancing with the Stars in Belgium.
And she won, I think.
I know somebody else, too. Let's see. Shailese Jones, 14-7-6-6 is the number.
He was crying.
He was crying.
So 14-7-6-6. Just remember that number. You got two athletes left, both from China. Wei Xiaoyan is next.
I'm really curious to know what her score is.
I'm sure she is, too. It's so close. What's that, 600th of a point?
Shailese is still in first.
By that much. Shailese Jones holds on to first place ahead of the reigning Olympic champ.
It's going to come down to the Chinese women to see if they can get on that podium.
Wei Xiaoyuan, the 18-year-old, qualified fourth with the 2021 world champ on uneven bars. Here we go.
In bar full pirouette. We can hear her teammates cheering. Beautiful pirouettes, one after the other. This is a dismount. Full twisting double layout and stuck. This is a party. This is...
How good have the top gymnasts been on uneven bars here?
Wow.
Thank you.
This is impressive.
So Jones, Derweil, the top two.
Thank you.
Wei Xiaoyan, will that number be enough
Another look at some of the elements here.
So she touches her toes on that release, the way that she begins it. A toe on, if you will. But in the beginning, she started her routines off with a handful of what we call in bars, where your feet don't touch. That is extremely difficult, and that's going to boost her start value. So I am curious. I don't know what she's going to get. I believe the score she got in with was a 14.6. However, her releases were a little bit low. Dare I mention again that Shailese Jones' release moves practically touched the ceiling. Beautiful dismount. Wei Xiaoyan. That was a hit routine, and that was quite packed.
So close at the top right now. 14.766 is the number she has to beat. Shailese Jones holding on to the lead from early on. She was the second one to go. And you've only got one left after Wei Xiaoyan. Here we go. Oh, it's good enough.
Takes the top spot.
Dropping Shailese Jones to second place.
Wow.
14.966, the number, and the reaction from Shailese Jones. Wei Xiaoyan looking to go back to back with one athlete left. Lo Rue, the 16-year-old, she's only 16 years old, and won the bronze medal at the World Championships on this event, 2021.
Her qualifying score was a 14.9.
Top qualifier for the final.
Xiaoyan just got a 14.966, and her entry score was a 14.6, so I expect a lot from this routine. Beautiful start. Look at those lines.
Oh.
And she's hit her heels on the bar. That is going to be quite a deduction. She's got ballerina feet. Beautiful pointed toes. Her lines are extended. Her start value is massive. Bit over the bar on that pirouette. You want to stop with your toes to the ceiling. Dismount.
And the step.
Oh, boy.
But that obvious error.
There have been many moments in the past where we'll have athletes with such jam-packed start values in their routines that they fall and they still get first. We've seen Simone do this. We've seen athletes in China do this. We've seen this in quite a number of places, so I do wonder where she's going to score and if she can still podium even with hitting her heels on the bar.
John, what do you make of what you've seen?
Well, I don't think we're going to see a podium from this routine right here. You know, I watched her in the qualifications and my jaw dropped. Honestly, it was so remarkable, the gymnastics she did. But just to put perspective on what we've seen in this bar final so far, it's a story of start values. Shailese Jones, as I said, went up there and she added 1/10 to her start value. She changed mid-routine. She connected two skills. That 1/10 is what kept her in front of Durweil. Durweil did not get credit for something that she also didn't get credit for in qualifications, which dropped her start value to a 6.3 as opposed to a 6.5, which would have put her ahead of Shailese. Then Wei goes up, and she does a start value that's 2/10 more than she did in qualifications. And look, she beats Shailese Jones by 2/10. Without that start value increase, they tie for gold. I mean, it was a story of gamesmanship and start values in this women's uneven bar finals. What a fun one to watch.
Yeah, right down to the last athlete, too, and that we'll see how costly that one error is. We'll see. Shailese Jones, who held the lead for much of the night. The Lo Rue waits for that final number, just 16, just getting started at this level. We got to be 16.
Gotta be 16.
Minimum. Wei Xiao Yuan.
We've got her heels on the bar.
Yeah, right there.
Ouch,
yeah.
That's going to leave a little bruise. That happens when you hang on too long to the bar. If you let go a little earlier, you sit up a little faster, your feet can clear the bar. But in this case, a lot of times also for these release moves, there's such high difficulty that the athlete can fear the adrenaline that they get. And the adrenaline can make you, you know, do higher release moves, but that adrenaline can also pull you really far away from the bar. Just a millisecond longer has you off the equipment.
Yeah, that's not close. 13-8, and that'll do it. Wei Xiao Yuan goes back to back. Remember, Nina Durweil did it 2018, 2019. And so the athlete from China wins the gold medal in the uneven bars.
Shai Jones comes in second.
And Shailese Jones, the U.S. champ in this event, wins the silver medal at the World Championships. The 20-year-old from Seattle will stand on the podium ahead of the reigning Olympic champ, Nina Durweil, and the two-time world champion. That's pretty good uneven bars final there, huh?
That was a fantastic uneven bars final. Lots of tension, lots of questioning, lots of back and forth motion.
So the 18-year-old from China, Wei Xiao Yuan, the winner last year and the winner again here in 2022. How many group photos do you have on your wall?
Oh, I don't have too many. My mom, on the other hand.
There you go. Yep, proud mom. All right, so look at the final standings here. Women's uneven bars. Wei Xiao Yuan from China, the gold. Shailese Jones, the silver medal. And Nina Durweil, the bronze, the Olympic champ, in third place.
That was such an exhilarating bar finals. I mean, I think we're going to be seeing a lot of this in the events to come, not just with women's, but with men's as well. We've got still rings coming up.
Fourth event of the day. We've got one left. As you mentioned, still rings for the men still to come from the World Championships. And then one more day of apparatus finals tomorrow from Liverpool. One more today, five more titles at stake. On the final day of the World Gymnastics Championships, look ahead to tomorrow, the men's vault and floor exercise. Jordan Chiles, Jade Carey, the reigning Olympic gold medalist, take on a talented field of gymnasts. There's Sky Blakely looking for her first world medal on the balance beam. And Brody Malone aims to improve on his high bar bronze that he won a year ago. That's all tomorrow, live at 8:30 a.m. Eastern on Peacock. Not done yet today, though. One more to go. Still rings still to come for the men. So here's a look at the lineup. The eight men who've made it to the final, including John Roethlisberger, Donnell Wittenberg. Your thoughts on this lineup as we get set for the last one of the day?
Well, Donnell is going to have the anchor spot. He goes last, so he'll know exactly what he needs to do to get a medal. But he's going to have his work cut out for him. Let's start with the Chinese gymnast. To me, even though that he's not the top qualifier, Zhou and Yu, they are going to be two of the men to beat. Certainly Courtney Tulloch did outstanding in the qualifications. But I'll tell you what, those two Chinese gymnasts, again, they set the bar, I think, on this event. And of course, Adam Aziel is going to be right in there as well. The top three gymnasts all tied. Their score actually tied. You had to go to a tiebreaker to seed them. So this one's going to be close.
Yo Hao from China, two-time world medalist, and Aziel and Tulloch, stars of the European Championships recently in 2022, but it will be Donnell Wittenberg, the 28-year-old from Baltimore, will be the last man up on rings here in the final, straight ahead from Liverpool. Six championships, one more to go here, still rings. And the men The eight names who will compete for the gold medal. Donnell Whitberg here, a chance in his fifth trip to the World Championships. By the way, you enjoying yourself?
I am. This is fantastic. And by the way, I love doing this with both of you. Thanks for having me.
Well, thanks for saying that. Great having you along. And you, John, of course, too.
Oh, yeah, Terry. It's just, that's a courtesy. Yeah, okay. I appreciate it.
And you too, John. No, it's been a thrill all week. We've been working together every day, though. So, thoughts on this lineup, John, and Donnell Whitberg here, last one to go.
Yeah, you know, I talked with USA Gymnastics earlier today, and they did say Donnell hasn't been feeling that well. He's been a bit under the weather, really going back to before the team qualification. But they did say when it comes time to do it, he will step up and do it. They may actually, going back to what we saw on bars with Shailese and some of the other athletes, they might adjust his start value. It'll come at the very beginning of his routine. I'll point it out. But he might change his start value, just try to get an extra 10th. It just depends on what the athletes have done before him. But here's the thing about a ring final. Unlike the other events, we've seen falls on every event final so far, right? Rings is not an event that athletes fall on. It's about how clean they can do it. Really, it's about who holds the best strength positions and who sticks the landing. I know that's simplifying it, but it could easily come down to a stick contest to see who gets gold here.
Got a couple of athletes from Armenia in this group, too, and no gymnast from Armenia has won a medal in still rings. Yukimoto, we've seen earlier throughout the championships. Japan won silver in the team event earlier this week. Your thoughts on, oh, listen, Donnell Whitberg here being introduced. For example, in the men's team event, China was just awful in qualifying. And then they won, not easily, but they were clearly the best. The difference between qualifying and the number you put up, where you place in qualifying, and then the real event.
Yeah, qualifying, a lot of times, especially like in prelims and things like that, little mistakes are almost bound to happen. It comes at the beginning of the competition, the beginning of Worlds, before finals starts. This meet happens, and so you're kind of getting those kinks out. We'll see a little bit lower scores, but now they've had time to warm up, they've had time to get used to the equipment, they are ready to go, and that's why we see lots of higher scores during finals.
Davtyan, the first two from Armenia, and then Yohao from China on down the list. Courtney Tulloch, who had a great moment with the team in Great Britain, making the podium early in the week, is certainly taking in all the cheers in the crowd in Liverpool, and then Donnell Whitberg will be the last one to go. This event, as much as anything for me, just as a fan, I just watch the entire, and I can't believe that it's possible to do what they do.
Oh, my arms would fall off. Easy.
Right.
There's no, as someone who's tried rings before, I simply cannot.
Well, like I mean, it's amazing what these men are able to do.
We were talking about, like, off-camera, shoulders earlier.
Right.
Like all the shoulders and shoulder injuries that we've sustained, you from basketball, me from gymnastics, I cannot imagine the amount of shoulder strength you have to do iron crosses on rings, anything on rings, just anything. I have a massive appreciation for everyone here.
Well, and then the training that's involved to do it over and over and over again to get to this point, and the wear and tear that puts on your body.
Joke's on my muscles. I don't think my bones are strong enough for rings. Like, that. This is going to be an interesting one to watch. And like John mentioned earlier, you know, we don't really see athletes fall on rings. That's not what we're looking for. What we're looking for is the little details. And at the end of the day, it may come down to a stick contest. Who can have the cleanest routine? Who can stick?
Hey, John, just the thought, because you've been there all week through the training and qualifying, individual all around, now team events as well. The crowd there has been sensational. I mean, not only have they shown up, but they have been on every second of every routine.
They really have. And I actually just talked to my colleagues here that are helping me with the broadcast. They're from Great Britain. And they said just that. They said the British crowds really appreciate greatness, no matter where it comes from and what part of the world. I'll tell you what, you mentioned the long trip here, and Chelsea Memel mentioned that to me earlier today from USA Gymnastics about how this is really a lot of work, and it's a marathon. You know, they have a lot of energy they expend through the team competition, and so this crowd absolutely makes a huge difference, not just to the hometown team, but to everybody competing.
Makes a difference as an athlete, right? I mean, again, not just to the athletes from Great Britain, which obviously they're the loudest when they're out there competing, but they've been in it every step of the way for every athlete. And as an athlete competing, it makes a difference whether it's quiet or whether they're going crazy.
Oh, it absolutely makes a difference. Well, that's what was interesting about Tokyo in 2021. We saw an entire competition with no crowd, no energy, no outside energy. It makes doing gymnastics really difficult when you don't have people out there watching you. Like, I remember, even if I were to go to practice and I start training, there's something about watching either little girls or some people around gym watching you do your routines, and you get this energy, this feeling of, oh, I'm being watched, I'm being perceived, I want them to watch, look how good I am, you know? So to go to Tokyo and to not have anyone watch in person how hard you've worked, it's...
Even knowing that there are millions and millions of people watching on TV, but they're not there.
They're not there. You can't hear them. You can't feel their present energy. That's why this competition is so exciting to watch for me, because you're seeing all these people in the crowd who are excited for every single athlete, especially for Great Britain, naturally, but for all athletes. They're applauding. They're invested. And that's what we want to see. We want to support these athletes. They're working so hard.
So Artur Avetisyan, the 24-year-old from Armenia, who qualified in seventh, his first appearance at the World Championships, first to go.
I'm noticing right at the get all this tape on his shoulders, signifying either injury, ache.
Overall, John,
a very good, great start. You know, he's got one of the lower start values here in the finals. You're going up first, that's a disadvantage for sure, but his positions were great. You know, you're going to see a lot of the Maltese position. Everybody knows that rings finals especially is all about strength. The Maltese position is the one where if you lay flat on the floor and put your arms out to the side, that's the Maltese. The one where it looks like you could iron your shirt on the guy's back, that is a very important skill on the rings. You'll see a lot of the athletes do two of those positions. Whoever does that the best certainly has an advantage on this event. This was a great routine, though. Really didn't leave a lot of room for the judges to take points off.
See, that should not be humanly possible.
I'm speechless. I don't... I simply could never...
So two athletes from Armenia start things off here in the still rings final. One who's 24 years of age, Artur, just getting things going, first world championship. And Megan Daptian, who is 34 years of age next and has last been at the world championships in 2018. but a chance for an athlete from Armenia perhaps to be on the medal stand for the first time. It still rings. Okay, 14-6 with the execution being 8.6. That's the standard that's been set now.
8.6? That's pretty good execution. Out of 10.
Agan Daptian from Armenia as well. Fifth in qualifying on rings. We watched his brother Artur win a bronze medal in Tokyo on vault. Sixth the last time he was at the World Championships in this event.
Agan does have a skill on rings named after him, the Daptian Cross. He performed this at the 2014 World Cup in Doha.
It was great. The irony of this routine is he held his strength parts extremely well. The worst hold position that he had in the entire routine was his handstand position. And he did multiple handstands, and it's almost like, man, just do one of those handstands, because that is where the judges are going to hit him the most. Even stuck his landing like his teammate did moments ago. That routine will not move ahead of his teammate, Artur. I'll tell you what, Artur got a 14-6. That would be the second highest ring score in qualification for the first guy up to get that number. That is a big hurdle for the rest of the field to overcome.
Yeah, Artur in qualifying 14-4-6-6. So much better here in the actual final. As a gymnast, to have a skill named after you is pretty special too, isn't it?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, you've taken a sport that already feels like it's done everything under the sun, and now you've created something new and you've done it on a world stage. That is definitely something to be proud of.
I have a skill named after me if you want me to comment on it.
I do, actually, and I would love to hear all about it, and that is not sarcasm. Please tell me about it.
I have a really ugly skill on parallel bars that no one in the world actually does because it's so ugly.
Be nice.
They just don't do it. So, but it is in the code of points, so I'm very proud of that, actually.
Nobody else calls it ugly. Just you, self-effacing.
You call it ugly.
Exactly.
Nice to my friend, John Roethlisberger.
They tell me right to my face, actually.
Okay, so 14-5-3-3, and John, you're absolutely right. It's good. It's solid. Really good, but not good enough to overtake Artur. Tsitsian, the leader.
The People's Republic of China. You have.
So Yohao will be next, and he's 30 years of age, the Olympic silver medalist from Tokyo, and a two-time world medalist as well.
So an exciting thing about Yohao is we've got an incredible sequence to start. He pulls up from hang through inverted cross, then lowers back down and pulls from hang to legs together planche. Unbelievable. Also, notice his hold positions. He's not moving.
16 double A dismount. That's a quite a big step on the landing. John?
Ooh. Yeah, that's going to kill him. That huge step is a major deduction for him. And as close as I expect this ring final to be, I told you a stick contest, right? He did not stick, and he's opening the door. But you mentioned the strength moves. You know, these strength moves, the whole positions that he has, as good as you possibly can do it. I mean, brace yourself for another one of my analogies. It's like my kid sitting at the dinner table with his green beans on the plate that he doesn't want to eat. He just flicks a few off to the dogs on the floor. That's how I feel like he treats these strength moves. Like, they're so easy for him. It's a level that you don't see really in the world, in my opinion.
And you allow that at the dinner table. Huh.
As long as he can do a good Maltese, he can do that.
Okay. During this routine, Lori, it not only drew applause, but there were some oohs and ahs in the crowd. You know, the different position, the different hold. Well, there's the step. Not on the step at the end, obviously. That'll be a big mistake. But
on his holds.
Yeah.
The way that he held everything. I mean, that's of you that person. That's what still rings is all about, you know?
Still.
Being still, truly not moving, holding as if it was just a photo. That's, in my opinion, that's as close as you can get.
He's won a silver and a bronze at the World Championships, but not a gold. Won a gold on parallel bars back in 2015, and then that silver at the Olympics on rings in Tokyo. No expression. I mean, that's the other thing. Jim just tried to play it off. No expression. This isn't tough.
Oh, yeah, no.
This isn't hurting.
Difficult?
Yeah.
I actually have never learned that word before. I don't know what that is.
There's the ooh. 14-6, so it's right in between. It's the same as the top number. Tiebreak in second. So it's Avetesyan in first with the same number, though.
I love the oohs and ahs of the crowd.
So the execution score breaks that tie. Ademesio from Turkey made his Olympic debut in Tokyo, was seventh there. The European silver medalist, 2022, now up on rings.
Boss.
Qualified for all-around final, but actually withdrew the day before.
I think he was pleased.
Oh, look at that crowd.
I think they're pleased. John, you pleased?
That was a great performance. Adam Azil, he's an interesting guy. You know, he started his career in Egypt. Didn't feel like the Egyptian Federation was supporting his dream of being an Olympic champion. So he moved to Turkey, where he has turned around his gymnastic career. Talked with him earlier this week. And he is a passionate man. He said he is going to go and compete in gymnastics until he is an Olympic champion. And I tell you what, that routine he just did right now, it might just be good enough for a world champion. It was an outstanding performance.
Step by step in that road to an Olympic gold and the world championship here, part of the journey.
I get a little choked up every time I watch an athlete recognize that they hit a fantastic routine. And then the camera turns to their family and their support system and their teammates, and they're cheering them on as well. Oh.
Youngest man in the final at the age of 23. John, that was terrific.
Yeah, one thing I think is going to be interesting, he does an inverted cross that's clearly not as good as Yo did in the routine just before him. And so I think it could be a 3-10 deduction, but Yo had the big deduction on his landing, so it's a little bit of a give and take. I think this will be good enough to get into this top spot for now.
So that moment where we are about to find out, and then there'll be four more left. It is good enough. Almost 15, 14, 9, 3, 3.
Wow.
Adem Aziz from Turkey. Crunching the numbers, John?
Yeah, it's going to be hard to beat that number. Obviously, the biggest number we've had so far in rings here at these World Championships. But I feel like the judges are also being a little bit more lenient on their score. So you got Zhou and you got Tulloch from Great Britain, Zhou from China, Tulloch from Great Britain. Those two guys in particular, they can push it, but they've got to be perfect. Perfection is the only thing that you can do from here on out if you want gold.
So Jing Yuan, part of that last group of gymnasts, he'll be first to go, and it'll end up with the American Donnell Wittenberg. So they know what they have to do. And that, as a gymnast, I mean, not that you're going to change a whole lot. There's Donnell right there in his fifth World Championships. But you know the benchmark, the number that's out there that you have to top.
Yeah, I'm really curious to know how much Wittenberg is perceiving and absorbing the competition around him. You know, same with all the other athletes, but I do wonder.
Are you
if
in your own zone? Are you?
Me personally, yes.
Yeah.
I genuinely never have any idea of what's happening around me. And it's done on purpose. I don't want to know. I don't even want to know my own scores. I just want to keep moving with the competition. And, like, I can recognize if I've done the best routine that I can do.
Sure.
But we'll see. For some people, that gives them the fuel to keep doing a better routine.
Yeah, the athletes are different. And some are motivated by a number up there, a great routine that they've seen. There is Donnell, 28-year-old from Baltimore. With more on him, here's John again.
Yeah, I mean, he's got his work cut out for him. We talked earlier about how he might change his routine to add some difficulty. Absolutely going to have to do that. If he does change his routine, it's right at the beginning. He does a back roll up to a legs together planche, the planche position being what looks like a high Maltese position. It'll only add 1/10. And talking about start values, really that is an interesting saga here on rings. Adem Aziz was 4/10 lower than Yu Hao from China on start value at a 6-7 versus a 6-3. But the execution side, Adem Aziz beat him by almost 1 point in execution. So that strategy for Adem paid off. The risk reward, not so much for Yu.
It is a man representing Turkey who has the lead right now. First gold medal at the World Championships was a teammate of his, Ibrahim Çolak, who is coming back from injury. But Adem Aziz has dedicated a lot of his success lately, European silver medal on rings, to his teammate. Right now could be on the verge of winning a gold medal at the World Championships. Already celebrating. Because, I mean, he can't do anything right now but wait and watch. Zhou, Tulloch, Yuyakumoto from Japan, and then Donnell Wittenberg, the final four to go on still rings in the last individual event of the day.
For Zhou, who's coming up next, he does an iron cross in a V position. The only gymnast to do that, and should get it named after him. That is going to be an exciting watch, and it's something that I'm looking out for.
Been watching him throughout the week. Part of that team from China that won the gold medal again. 12 of the last spring, 15 gold medals have been won by China. Trying to win gold here on still rings. Zhou Qingyuan, a 24-year-old.
Look at that. the only guy to do that in this competition. That's an incredible show of strength.
Song touchdown, but with a step. What do you got, John?
Yeah, the reason the Chinese aren't going to win gold on this event is this is the stick contest we talked about. Again, a step forward on the landing, shoulders were low, and it's just it's as close as it is on the rings between these athletes, meaning the strength positions and the swing moves as well. It comes down to the landing, and they clearly got beat by as much as 0.6 per athlete from China compared to the rest of the field just on the landings. That is just too much to overcome.
Love those moments when he was looking right into the camera and basically saying, don't try this at home.
Hey, John, I'm noticing a lot of these male athletes have a lot of taped shoulders going on. And I know that there's so many events for y'all that are strenuous on your arms, but how much of a toll on your shoulders does rings take on you?
Oh, hey, whenever I go play baseball with my kid in the street in front of our house, I remember rings. Let's put it that way. But I also wonder, I see that tape too, Lori, and I go, there's no way that tape is helping you out when you're doing a ring routine. It seems absurd to me.
I'm going to watch you throughout the first pitch at a baseball game just to see the toll it's taking on.
Going to put us side by side.
Yeah. All right, so 14-8-6-6, though, into second place. Even with the step at the end, it's MSL, though, the top spot as it gets loud for the next athlete up. Listen to this place. Courtney Tulloch, who qualified first for this rings final. From Great Britain in the crowd. How about that feeling when you've got the entire house right in the palm of your hand, John?
Wow, it is electric in here, no doubt. And I have got to say, all the finals, we've seen five so far. This has been by far the best as far as how these athletes has performed. And once I saw those big scores, those 14-9s and 14-8s go up, I thought to myself, no one's going to pass that up. And then Courtney Tulloch goes up and does this. As good as he can absolutely perform it, and really, honestly, it's hard for me to find deductions. The one area, his dismount, it wasn't quite laid out. And I know I'm being nitpicky, but if you got to find a separator from the top guys and Courtney, that could be as much as a 3/10 deduction. But again, just swinging for the fences, and he nailed it.
Well, less than a 10th of a point right now separates the top two. How about your thoughts on Zoe and what we saw, the at least what the judges thought of that last routine before telling?
I was a little surprised to see that high of a score of over a 14-8. That landing could have been a 6/10 landing. The judges clearly didn't take that much.
Exactly.
But, again, great routine. But it's, you know, my wife would like to hear this. Every once in a while, I am right. And I told you it was going to be a stick contest for gold, and so far it has been.
Jury's still out on that. 14-9-3-3 is the top number right now. Adem Esil from Turkey. Courtney Tulloch. Here we go. Oh, no, it's not close to that. 14-7-3-3, John.
Well, again, if you're separating Adem Esil and that routine, again, I said he was piked in the air on his dismount. That's up to a 3/10, probably a 3/10 deduction. Add that three, and where does he end up? Just ahead of it. So, again, that's how fine and how precise these guys have to be.
Two more left. Yuya Komoto from Japan, the 28-year-old who qualified sixth, part of that Japan silver medal in the team event. And then it's Donnell Whitberg.
So fast, and then to have to stop and be still. Can't imagine how much strength that takes.
And a step.
The chest down on that landing. Step back.
So, John, if it does come down to that, there's that extra step at the end.
Yeah, not going to happen, unfortunately. Or Komoto. He had some execution errors on the rings as well. But I love the double layout holding onto the rings. That's called an O'Neill, named after Paul O'Neill, an American gymnast. He goes right from that to the Maltese. I love to see gymnasts break it up a little bit. Do something new. Do something different. You know, stuff like that probably got him into the finals. He's going to have to be a little better in the future if he wants to medal. But a fun routine to watch.
So Adem Esil, Zoe of China, and Tulloch of Great Britain, the top three with one athlete still left, Donnell Whitberg. For the numbers now for Yuya Komoto of Japan, 14-4-6-6 in the seventh place. With one man left, Donnell Whitberg, John.
Yeah, Donnell's going to have to be perfect. And just to put it in perspective, Courtney Tulloch from Great Britain had a 6-1 start value. If Donnell Whitberg changes his routine and adds the back roll to the flounge at the beginning, like you talked about, he will also start from a 16.1. So if you can rewind that routine from Courtney Tulloch and compare it to Donnell Whitberg's right here, you guys can decide who's better. It's going to come down to execution.
Here is the two-time U.S. Still Rings champ.
Opens his hands on this iron cross, increasing the difficulty. Oof.
This young man, he has had a resurgence of sorts this year, made this world championship team, came in, performed well, did three outstanding ring routines, got in what was the toughest final of these worlds so far, performed well. Something to build on. I think he'll be back here and he'll have another chance.
Won a bronze medal on vault back in 2015 and was actually a part of the last U.S. men's team to make it to the podium. That was in 2014. So he's now 28 years old. And you're right about a resurgence. I mean, this year at the U.S. Championships, second in the all-around, second in the vault, won the rings championship again. Kind of knew it? You think the look on that face at the end?
I think so. He mentioned something about his second Maltese when he came off.
14-4-3-3, so that'll do it. Donnell Wittenberg ends up in eighth place. It is Adem Asil from Turkey. He can't believe it. Who wins the gold medal. Pretty cool.
This is such a special moment.
Zhou Jingyuan, the silver and the first medal for Great Britain in this event. Courtney Tulloch, the bronze.
Between Gianni and Courtney, I think Great Britain has some medals from today.
And from the week, too.
And from the week,
some,
of course.
Some first evers, you know. I mean, making some history at home in Liverpool. But that man right there, this is the moment for him. And how many times growing up do you imagine this moment and then actually realize it?
Honestly, each athlete has a very specific moment of being proud of themselves. And it's so fantastic when you're able to watch. We just watched Adem Asil do that. To put the flag around himself and to truly be proud of what he did.
Absolutely. So, the action complete for the day. Five different event finals. You got five more tomorrow, but final standings here. That's how close it was. Less than, what, a tenth of a point. Adem Asil, Zhou Jingyuan, the silver. Courtney Tulloch, what a performance with the bronze. And Donnell Wittenberg ends up in eighth here in the final in his fifth trip to the World Gymnastics Championships. So the action done for the day. We are now. We'll come back and wrap things up in a moment here as we continue with Worlds. Action from Liverpool.
It has been a full day of gymnastics from the World Championships in Liverpool. Started with the men's floor and Gianni Gini Moran doing things like that to start things off.
Double twisting, double pack, second pass. We have his last pass here. Beautiful, stuck, triple full, earning him the gold.
Yeah, it was
individual
great.
Floor finals.
It was great. The building just went crazy at that point. Top step of the podium, an athlete from Great Britain. All right, how about the women's vault and the Americans in the mix, Jordan Childs?
First up, we're showing Jordan's vault. A stunning Yurchenko double full, something to be proud of. Also, another almost stuck landing right here. Fantastic. We've got Jade Carey's vault as well. Does a powerhouse of a Cheng. She comes up on her second. Yurchenko double full. Nice and clean.
Disappointment at the Olympics in the vault. Celebrations here with her teammate, though. The top two, gold for Carey, silver for Jordan Childs. And then it was to pommel horse for the men. Steven Nedorozic came in as the defending champ, but this man, boy, he was ahead of Nedorozic in terms of where they went, and he laid down a number, Rhys McLennan from Ireland, that just couldn't be touched.
And that's a gold first place medal for Ireland at Worlds. Go, Rhys!
He's won a medal before in this at Worlds, but never a gold. This is the first time. Great stuff. The women on uneven bars. Shailese Jones coming in.
Look at this height. Absolutely beautiful, earning her the silver medal. Wonderful. High fives all around. Chelsea Memel.
Had the lead for much of the final, but Wei Xiao Yuan from China with this effort here.
Jam-packed routine.
Good enough for the gold. Shailese Jones captures the silver medal. And then it ended with still rings. Came right down to the end. Adema Sildo from Turkey. You know, he gets done with this routine and he just lets it all out.
Dismount right here and then he just yells. That moment of knowing, and he knew he had it in him.
Had to wait though. Had to wait for four more athletes to go. And the separation at the top wasn't much in the end, but he does capture it. So you look at the medalists from today's action.
Gini what a Moran. Competition we've had today.
It was great. It was. It started off with all the excitement of a home team winning, home athlete winning, and then two Americans, top two spots in the women's vault. Rhys McLennan was outstanding at pommel. And then uneven. Wei Xiao Yuan, just ahead of Shailese Jones. Nina Durweil, the Olympic champ, with the bronze medal. Demasio from Turkey, winning the gold medal in still rings. And Courtney Tullock, the first medal for Great Britain in rings at home, Liverpool.
Woohoo! I loved that the crowd welcomed all these athletes today. Lots of cheers, lots of excitement, and lots of fantastic energy.
You sure? Because we're not done. We come back tomorrow. Okay, good. I'm glad you're looking forward to it. I was. Men's vault and the balance beam for the women. Parallel bars. Women's floor exercise and the men's high bar with Brody Malone, who won a bronze medal at the World Championships on that event last year. And we started an hour earlier at 8:30 a.m. Eastern time. So look ahead to tomorrow. Lori and I will be back with you. John Roethlisberger as well. But great action from the World Championships throughout the week. Started with team events, then the individual all-around finals, and now a weekend of apparatus finals. Day one in the books tomorrow. Day two, 8:30 a.m. Eastern time. For Lori Hernandez, John Roethlisberger, and our entire NBC Sports crew, I'm Terry Gannon. See you tomorrow once again, everybody. We'll be right back.
Sebastian Martinian. In second place, and winner of the silver medal, representing Jordan, Ahmed Abu Al-Soud. And in first place, winner of the gold medal and world champion, representing Ireland, Reese McLanigan. please showing appreciation for our World Championship medal. Ceremony for the men's rings final is about to commence. Please welcome our medalists and presentation party into the arena. Representing the People's Republic of China, Su Jingwen. Those who can, please now stand for the national anthem of Türkiye.